number one clock watcher, Gary Kroger.
Thank you. Each of these teams wants to win our game and a chance to grab all they can in our swirling whirlwind of over $25,000 in cash and prizes. Teams, how would you like to earn 10 points all to start the game? I have a relatively simple task for you. When I say beat the clock, guys, you're going to get out of those waders and the boots there, and you're going to put your wives into them and get across this line. The first to do so gets those 10 points and an early lead. Are you ready? All right. Then beat the clock. No trouble getting it off. Don't let the boots get inside out. Get the strap over your shoulder. Use strategy and skill to beat the clock. Hi, I'm Gary Kroger, and yes, Beat the Clock is back, and it's better than ever. I have three great couples, and they're here to compete for cash and prizes for winning that first game. All right, it's the gold team. They've got 10 points and the chance to start things off. Come on over here. We have Mindy and Rich DeRosa. You guys are married?
Yes.
And where are you from?
We're here from Florida. We live in Palm Bay.
Palm Bay, that's on the East Coast,
East Coast,
right?
Yes.
Now, you guys won the first round, so you have a choice to make. I'd like you to say hello to the beautiful Julie Lynn.
Thank you. Hello.
Hi.
Now, Julie Lynn has three items I want you to study because each one of these items will be used in a challenge today. This is a piece of an inner tube. It would be round. And this is a felt tip marker, and this is a cup that could hold water, conceivably, right? Now, you guys are going to choose who's going to use what. We've tested each one of these to make sure they're of equal difficulty, but what might be easy for you might be hard for them. You don't know till you try, right?
Sure.
What would you guys like to use for your challenge?
Cup.
Cup?
Going to use the cup. Choose for the red team, please.
Marker for the red team.
The marker, and so the inner tube is going to go to the blue team. Thank you very much, Julie Lynn. Now, everybody gets 30 seconds to complete their challenge, but I want to give you 10 more seconds, give you a nice advantage. To do that, you have to earn it. I'm going to ask you a question that has at least two answers. Mindy, you'll go first. If you're correct, then Rich, you'll give me the other answer.
Okay.
All right? Can't confirm. The 2002 World Cup Final Championship for soccer was played between teams from what two countries, Mindy?
Germany and...
Germany is one of them. Nicely done, Rich. Give me the other.
Turkey.
No, good guess, because they were in the final. It was Germany and Brazil. I can't give you the 10 seconds, but you got 30. Come on over here. Now, Mindy, stay there for just a second. Rich, I want you to make yourself as comfortable as you can right in front of that ladder here. We're going to put a little protective plastic on you here. You'll soon find out why. And then sit down, grab right here. You'll notice you have a small bucket in front of you. And we're going to put this attractive apparatus, there's the cup that you chose, on your head. Now let's make sure that that's very secure. Mindy, come around this way, please. You'll notice that you have a big old bucket of water here and a number of pitchers. You will be filling these pitchers, as many as you want at a time, with that water going up to the third rung.
Okay.
Then you have to pour water into this glass. When it's full, tell him to dump it into this small bucket here. When it's over that red line, you have beat the clock. That seems simple enough?
Does he get up?
He's going wet.
Yeah, good luck to you. Okay, Mindy?
Is
he going to get up? Well, he can lean forward.
Lean forward.
He can lean forward. I thought you said, is he going to get wet?
No.
Well, that depends on you. Okay.
Are you
ready?
Yeah.
When I say beat the clock, pick it up, fill it with water, third round.
All right.
All right, 30 seconds are up there. Beat the clock. Very good. More points for every second left on the clock. Way to go.
Okay.
Clean yourself up. Let's say hello to the red team. Hi, Nancy.
Hello?
And Gary Kusher.
Yes, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you for asking. Where are you guys from?
We're from Hilton Head, South Carolina, Hilton Head Island, but we're originally from New York.
All right, now you saw the deal here. I want to give you 10 more seconds. You can see where that would be an advantage, right? I have a question, has at least two answers. Yes. Nancy, you'll go first if you're correct. Gary, you'll give me the other. What are the first names of Sound of Silence singers Simon and Garfunkel? Nancy?
Art.
It's one. Gary?
Peter.
Paul Simon. Oh. Paul Simon. You were thinking of Peter, Paul, and Mary. I can't give you the 10 seconds, but you got 30. Come on over here.
Okay.
Gary, I'm going to put you right here temporarily while I explain things. And I want you to come over here, Nancy. What's going to happen here is you see you've got this easel and you've got paper, and you were given the felt tip pen. Well, in 30 seconds, I'm going to give Nancy a country. And she's going to write it on this piece of paper. When you know what it is, you holler it out and you beat the clock.
Okay.
Yeah. Any country?
No, I'm going to give you a specific country. And
can we write anything? What words?
Can you write anything?
Words.
Well, you can write the name of the country would be the best thing to do.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you can draw the country if you want, but I think writing it out would be the best way to do it.
Okay.
But, Nancy, I think you think it's going to be a lot simpler than it is. Because this is how you're going to write it. If you would just step this way, please.
Okay.
That's where the pen is, right here. So, you see, there was a little catch. Let's enter it up here. So, this is how you'll be writing with your back to the easel. Now, if you have a letter that you think it is, go ahead and holler it out. She'll tell you if you're correct or not.
I can guess the whole country.
If you can guess the whole country quickly, guess the whole country. All right? You've got 30 seconds to do this. If you would come this way with me, that's what you'll be spelling or drawing, however you want to do it. And you've got 30 seconds to do so.
Okay.
Okay? Put yourself right here. All right?
Yep, I'm ready.
Beat the clock! Yourself comfortable there. Let's meet the blue team. Bridgette and Randall Davis.
All right.
Where are you guys from?
Lake Charles, Louisiana.
Louisiana? What do you do down there in Louisiana?
I'm a pre-K teacher.
What do you do, Randall?
I'm an operations manager for an industrial heavy equipment company.
Excellent. All right. Now, you saw the deal here.
I got 30 seconds. I'd love to give you 10 more, give you a little more time. Here's a question. She has at least two answers. Bridgette, you'll go first. If she's correct, then Randall, you'll give me the other answer.
Okay.
In the game of chess, what two regal, powerful pieces start the game lined up between the bishops? Bridgette.
The pawn?
No. Between the bishop, the king, and the queen. I cannot give you the extra 10 seconds, but you got 30. Come on over here. All right, now, when I say beat the clock, here's what you have to do. Each one of you have to get in each inner tube here and get it up here and step in the next and get all of them around your bodies, right? There are 12 of them.
Right.
When you have all 12, you can no longer use your hands to hold them up.
Okay.
You've got to keep them up, however, and get across that line right there. You've got 30 seconds to do this. That means you'll be moving.
Okay.
You got a question?
So I have to get it on me first.
You get it on both of you. Both of you need each ring around you.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
All right. You got it. Get in position. 30 seconds. Beat the clock. There you go.
They
gave it a good effort. Nice try. Not quite enough to beat the clock. All
three teams have now played, but when it's over, only two teams will still be in our game. One of them could win this.
DK Publishing presents KISS, the Keep It Simple series. Guides that inspire and instruct with all the information you'll need. The KISS books from DK Publishing. Bush offers a casual contemporary feel in an entertainment center with curved glass doors, adjustable shelves, and panoramic curio lighting from Bush Furniture. Stay tuned. There's more Beat the Clock coming your way.
Team Mindy and Rich are 2-for-2. That puts you in first place going into the elimination round. Now, the winning couple will have a chance to enter our swirling whirlwind of cash and prizes. In addition to a whole lot of cash, here's what else a lucky couple could grab and take home.
From Oneida, striking stainless flatware in the satin Aquarius pattern. A 20-piece service for four, plus hostess set and serving set. Oneida, your table is ready.
So, we have more prizes, but soon there will be fewer players. Only the first two teams to complete this challenge will move on. One of them will have to say goodbye to. Here's what you have to do. Ladies, you'll notice we have 3/5 of the Olympic rings down here. You guys are going to be moved to your respective circles according to your score. You're going to take your team ball. All you have to do is throw it through that ring. The first two teams to do so move on. Now, you've got the best score, so Mindy, come on over here. I'm putting you the closest. There's your yellow ball. Nancy, come on over here. You are a bit farther back because your score is not quite as high. And Bridgette, come over here. You have the lowest score going into this round, so you're the farthest back. But a good throw, and you can do it. Because, guys, you can bob and weave. You can't leave your circle there, but you can help them, except you can't use your hands, of course. Now, if you gals miss, you are the ones that have to go retrieve the ball and get back to your circle and try again. All right, first two teams. You can do it any way you want. I see Nancy's already got a new strategy. Here we go. Beat the clock. There's one. Yellow team has moved on. Quickly now. Quickly.
Come on,
not quite.
Come on, run.
No, not quite. Come on. Get your circle. Through first. I hate to say goodbye to anyone. That was so close. I do have to say goodbye to you. You are going to go home with a year's subscription to Gruner and Yar USA magazines. That includes Family Circle, Parents, and Rosie. That's worth over $250. And a lot of applause. Thank you so much. Now it's down to a face-off between the gold team and the blue. Only one of them will have a chance at the cash and prizes. Let's look at the challenge that stands in their way. As demonstrated by our uniquely qualified stunt testing division, each of you will be harnessed to these horizontal bungee cords. One will have a supply of teacups, the other will have a supply of saucers. One at a time, one grabs a cup, one grabs a saucer to build a stack of 5 cups and saucers. If anything falls, you have to restack them. The starting time to do this is 2 minutes, but these two teams will bid for the right to do it in even less time. A team will win the game either by beating the clock or by bidding the opposing side into defeat. Now, Mindy and Rich, you finished that elimination round first, so you have a choice to make. I'm going to ask a question. Don't answer it. If you think that Rich knows the answer, let him. If he's right, you'll start the bidding, which is a nice strategic advantage. If you don't think he knows, you can challenge Randall here. But if Randall's correct with the answer, they'll start the bidding. All right? You know what's at stake there? Here's the question. What is the main ingredient in the Italian dish risotto?
Rich, answer.
Rich, answer that.
Pasta.
Rice is the main ingredient. Rice. Rice. All right, that means they lost the challenge, so you will start the bidding.
Okay.
Starts at 2 minutes.
Minute 30.
Minute 30.
One and a half.
120.
120.
120. 1 minute.
1 minute. You're letting him do all the answering here. 1 minute.
You can do it.
1 minute. I need to answer quickly now.
Beat the clock.
They say beat the clock at 1 minute. That's what we
do. 1 minute.
That means the blue team here will attempt to beat the clock in that time. If they do it, they win the game. If not, gold team won with their good bid. Who's it going to be? I don't know. You find out. Come on back. Welcome back. Bridgette and Randall are all set to beat the clock. They have 1 minute to do so. Now, if they do, they win the game and they go into that swirling whirlwind. If they don't, then Rich and Mindy, the gold team over here, won with their clever bidding. Now remember, guys, what you have to do is make one stack of five cups and five saucers, grabbing one at a time. Are you ready?
Yes.
Ready. Ready.
Okay. Minutes up there. Beat the clock. There's one. It falls down. They start over. Make it secure. 50 seconds. It's a little wobbly. There's three. There is four. 40 seconds. It has to stay. There's two. 27 seconds.
Come on.
Three. 22. Four. That's it. They did it. They did it with 12 seconds to spare. Congratulations, you guys. They were awfully fast. It looked like touch and go for a little while, but they did it in enough time. I have to say goodbye to you guys. You did win from Ricardo Beverly Hills, an exciting, fashionable piece of luggage on wheels designed to make traveling easy and all this affection for you. As for our champs, when we come back, they grab as much as they can in our swirling whirlwind of cash and prizes. You stick around. Champs for Louisiana, Bridgette and Randall, congratulations.
All right.
Thank you.
Guys came all the way from last place.
Oh, yes.
And right. Now here you are.
Yes.
And now you're going to go into our swirling whirlwind for 60 seconds.
All right.
And you're going to grab all the cash and all the prizes you possibly can.
That's all right.
Okay.
That's right. Now you're wearing protective goggles because it really does swirl in there. The winds are strong. We also gave you some gloves to help you grab that cash, grab the money, and stuff it into this bag. That's where it's got to be when the 60 seconds are up. It has to be in the bag. Now, if it's on the floor, you can kick it, get it in the air, and grab it in the air, but you can't reach down and pick it up, scoop it up, you can't grab it off your feet.
No.
All right? Now, I've got over $25,000 in there that can be yours, plus these special gift vouchers, which I'm going to toss in here, because if you grab one of those, you could go home with one of these.
Oh.
Quality bedding by Waverly. Enjoy springtime all year long with Waverly's bright and cheery tropical floral Samoa, made in the USA by Waverly. Argus internet-ready digital camera with color LCD display and voice recording capability. Sleek styling with an innovative design for today's lifestyle. An American tradition since 1936 from Argus. Ashley's casual country-style Asheville dining collection. All wood construction designed in a classic two-tone finish to add charm to any decor. From Ashley.
All right, I can tell you're excited about those. Now remember, when the clock stops, you have to put up your hands. That's when you stop as well. I get the whirlwind going first, then you'll see me go beat the clock. That's when you start grabbing.
Okay.
Any questions?
No.
Then let's get on in there.
Let's get busy.
You all right?
I'm all right.
Okay. Clock is set. She is excited. Set at 60 seconds. Going to count down from there. Start the whirlwind, please.
Beat the clock.
We'll let it all settle down. It is swirling. Come on out here. All right, Randall, I'm going to take that sack here, and we're going to give that to Julie Lynn. She's going to take it off and count it, and let's see how you did. How do you feel that you did?
Oh,
can breathe it.
Yeah, it's where you can take those goggles off and relax a little bit now. Feel like you got some things?
Yeah.
You think you got any coupons?
I think so.
I think you did, too.
I know I did.
All right, let's find out. Julie Lynn, what do we have?
Oh, goodness. Bridget, you must be an amazing teacher because you learned a lot about grabbing the cash from the prizes in there.
All right. There's no such thing as being able to give teachers enough money, but how about $2,250? There's more. There's some books that I know you'll both enjoy, your students can enjoy. And we have a digital camera for you. And that's going to come in handy. You might take some pictures and send them to us because you're going to Aruba. Grand total of $5,762. I love this job. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm Gary Kroger.
And I'm Julie Lynn.
Make sure you're on time. The next time, it's time to beat the clock.
Dr. IQ, the mental banker.
I have a lady doctor. I have a gentleman doctor.
And I have silver dollars for your correct answers. And here he is, the wise man with a friendly smile, Dr. IQ.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, everyone. We greet you from AVC Television Center in Hollywood. Our program is entirely unrehearsed. We suggest you people at home play right along with our studio contestants to see how many silver dollars you could win. Out in the audience are my two lovely assistants with their portable microphones. I'd like you to meet them right now. On my left, Miss Sue England.
Thank you, Doctor.
And on my right, Miss Carol Byron.
Thank you, Doctor.
I'd like to remind you that sometime during our program tonight, you will hear this signal. Listen. Now, when you hear that signal, whoever I'm talking to at the time will have the opportunity of spinning the wisdom wheel and winning up to $100 in cash. Let's begin our program this evening as we go first to my left, then Miss Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Marianne Garra from Honolulu, Hawaii.
All right, Marianne. You know, friend of the children and scourge of the rats was the famous Pied Piper. For eight silver dollars, what town did the Pied Piper rid of rats? Eglin, Baconlin, or Hamlin?
England.
England? Your choices are Eglin. Eglin, is that your choice? I'm very sorry. It happens to be Hamlin. But we have for you a souvenir Dr. IQ silver dollar. Thank you very much for being with us. Over now to Carol Byron.
I have a gentleman doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir.
Leonard Rosenthal, Chicago, Illinois.
All right, Leonard, for 10 silver dollars for what word is ABBR, the abbreviation?
Abbreviation.
Yes, sir, that's right. For what is it the abbreviation? Oh, you mean that's your answer?
Yes, sir.
You're right, for 10 silver dollars, absolutely. Don't let me talk you out of those right answers. Let's go over now to Sue England.
I have a gentleman doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir?
Eugene Pucci of Rochester, New York.
Happy to have you with us, Mr. Pucci. This is for 15 silver dollars. President Eisenhower celebrated his birthday on October 14th. Now, within one candle, if you, Mr. Pucci, had baked a birthday cake for President Eisenhower, how many candles would you have put on his cake this year?
68.
You're right on the nose for 15 silver dollars. Yes, sir. 68 years of age, our president. Let's go over now to Carol Byron on the right.
I have a lady doctor.
What is your name and your hometown, please?
Mrs. Audrey McClinic, Maslin, Ohio.
From Ohio, Maslin, Ohio. This is for 7 silver dollars. If you were to call Kitty, 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 the animal most likely to respond would say meow.
Now, you imitate the animal that would most logically respond to the call of Suey, Suey, Suey.
A pig.
You imitate the animal. I don't want to hear the name. What is it?
Oi, 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 oi.
That's worth $7. Now, let's go over to my right and Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
What is your name in your hometown, please?
Evelyn Dyer, Washington, D.C.
Happy to have you with us, Evelyn. This is for $11. You know, their eyelashes give camels the most glamorous eyes in the animal kingdom. Now, why do camels have such long eyelashes? So their eyes won't get strained too much by the desert sun? So they won't get too much sand in their eyes? Or so they will look attractive to other camels?
I'll try to keep the sand out of their eyes.
You're going to try that? That's worth $11. That's the right answer. Let's go now to Carol Byron on the right.
I have a gentleman doctor.
What is your name in your hometown, sir?
John Farrell from London, England.
From London, England.
That's
We're
right.
very happy to have you, John.
Thank
this
you.
Is for $6 to take back to London. The famous words, out, damn spot, out, I say, were written by the owner of the first cleaning and pressing shop in America, yes or no?
Definitely no.
You're definitely right for $6. Those are the words, of course, of Mr. Shakespeare. Back to the back row in Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Mrs. D. Turner, Hollywood, California.
From Hollywood. All right, this is for $18, ma'am. If an uncle died and left you a lazy strap, a blind, crupper, belly band, hames, check brain, throat latch, winker stay, bag swiveling, crown piece, what would you have to buy in order to make use of them?
A horse.
You say a horse, you're right, for $18. We got a mighty sharp audience tonight, and now let's go over to Carol Byron.
I have a very young gentleman, doctor.
How do you do, sir? What is your name in your hometown?
Larry Osborne of Burbank.
Your name is Larry Osborne, and you have kind of red hair, isn't it, Larry?
Yeah, I guess so.
All right, Larry, let's see what we have for a question for you. Let's go back to the flapper era. I don't think you could go back that far, so I'm going to ask you this one. By logical reasoning, you can figure this one out, Larry. In the story of Alibaba and the 40 Thieves, the words, open sesame, were said to make a door open. Now, for $20, what words were said to make the door close? You can figure this one out by logical reasoning, you know.
Shut.
You say shut? Well, I tell you what, on my card it says closed sesame, but I think you can get them closed with shut, so I'm going to give you $20, Larry. Thank you very much for being with us. Let's go over now to my left, and Miss Sue England.
I have a lady doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Mrs. Zelda Roth from Van Nuys, California.
Your last name is what?
Roth.
Mrs. Roth?
Yes.
Mrs. Roth, would you please stand by, for in just one moment, I would like to ask you our famous quotation question.
Every day, Monday through Friday, exciting courtroom drama is yours for the viewing on most of these ABC television stations on Day in Court. You'll eavesdrop on criminal and civil cases presided over by Judge Edgar Allen Jones, Jr., as both accused and accuser are heard telling their fascinating stories on the witness stand. Based on actual court cases, the cases you witness reveal the conflicts and absorbing personal stories which unfold each day on our courts. Sharing the bench with Judge Jones on Day in Court is Judge William Gwynn, who hears domestic relations and juvenile matters. Judge Gwynn's decisions deeply affect the lives of the families, parents, and young people who come before him, providing you with compelling television viewing. You'll see Day in Court at a new time, 2 p.m. every weekday, starting this coming Monday on the ABC Television Network. That's Day in Court, Monday through Friday at 2 on ABC.
Once more, we come to that gem of wisdom, our famous quotation question. We have Mrs. Roth standing by. Mrs. Roth, if you have the correct answer to our famous quotation, you are going to win $25. If, however, you do not answer it correctly, the same quotation next week will be worth $50. So, Mrs. Roth, are you ready for our famous quotation?
Yes.
All right, here it is. What famous man said, in any event, I shall do my best. I shall keep the soldier's faith. No coaching on this, please. 5 seconds, Mrs. Roth. For $25, what is your answer, please?
President Eisenhower.
I am very sorry, ma'am. That is not the correct answer. That means the next week, this same quotation will be worth 50 silver dollars. But, Sue, give that lady a Dr. IQ souvenir silver dollar along with our compliments. Thank you, ma'am. Over now to Carol Byron.
I have a lady, Doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Dorothy Seltzer from Cortland, New York.
Dorothy Seltzer from Cortland, New York. Dorothy, once more we come to that little monument to memory, the Thought Twister, which I will say one time and one time only. If you can repeat it after me exactly as I say it, I will give you 35 silver dollars. Are you ready for the Thought Twister?
Yes, I am.
All right, listen to this.
Never.
All right. Lily is chilly, said Willie to Billy. Lily is chilly, Willie. To him, said Billy. Would you repeat that, please?
Lily is chilly, said Willie to Billy. Billy is... Billy is chilly to...
It's getting kind
Willie
of cool all over, isn't
to
it?
To him,
Donna?
Said Willie...
It's that time of year, but I'm sorry, the last line you did not have correct. It should read, Lily is chilly, said Willie to Billy. Lily is chilly, Willie to him, said Billy. See how easy it really is. Give that lady a Dr. IQ silver dollar. Thank you, ma'am. Let's go over now to Sue England on my left.
I have a lady, doctor.
What is your name and your hometown, please?
Pauline says Manchester, England.
From Manchester, England, this is your lucky evening. You hear that signal? That means that this is your opportunity to spin our wisdom wheel and win up to 100 silver dollars. As Sue England brings you down, I'll explain to you just how it works. You see, you can win any amount. Come right up here, if you will. What is your name once again?
Pauline Sayers.
Pauline what?
Sayers.
Pauline Sayers. Pauline... You can win anywhere from $1 all the way up to $100, and of course, all these numbers in between represent silver dollars. You just simply spin this wheel, and wherever it stops, let's say it stops there, there's a card above it, and if you can answer that question, you've got five silver dollars or wherever it might end up. Now, that's pretty simple, isn't it?
Yes.
Could you use, say, $100?
Huh? Sure could.
You're from where? Manchester, England?
Yes.
What are you doing over here?
I'm working.
Oh, you're working? You're here for good, then, huh? Well, let's see if you can give this wheel a spin, and good luck to you. Give it a good spin, and then that's it. Now step right back, and let's take a watch. Just keep your eye on it. We'll keep our fingers crossed, huh? What do you think you want to go for, 100 or 50 or what? You know, the more money, the more difficult the question, huh? 100? Oh, it's up to 100. 1, 25, 20. It's going to stop on five silver dollars, so here is your slot. For five silver dollars, the question shouldn't be too rough. So... Now, I am thinking of something you put on a salad. It is named for seven big islands and 1,600 little islands in the St. Lawrence River near Lake Ontario. It's a salad dressing. What would you ask for if you wanted to order it in a restaurant for five silver dollars?
Island dressing.
Is that all?
A salad.
What is that?
Island dressing for salad.
Island dressing for salads on a dish over the napkin with a spoon. Is that... No, I mean, did anything before the salad, huh? You're trying to say a thousand island salad dressing?
Yes.
That's right, for five silver dollars. Thank you very much for spinning the wisdom wheel. Let's go back now to Carol Byron in the audience.
I have a gentleman, doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir?
D.L. McClintock, Burbank.
Is that McClintock?
That's right.
All right, sir, from Burbank. Now, Mr. McClintock, Bobby Hammock and the orchestra are going to play a few bars of a very familiar song for you. In fact, it's so familiar, it has three titles and three different sets of lyrics. Now, after Bobby plays a song for you, I will pay you five silver dollars for each of the titles you can name and 20 silver dollars if you can name all three. Listen. Now, Mr. McClintock, what are the three titles by which this song is known? Name as many as you can think of.
He's a Jolly Good Fellow.
For one. Is that all you can come up with, sir?
I won't get home until...
What is that?
I won't get home till morning.
That's number two. I'll give you 5 seconds to think of that third one. No coaching, please. Sir, the time is up. The third one is The Bear Went Over the Mountain. But you had two right. That earns for you 10 silver dollars. Congratulations to you, sir. Let's go over now to Sue England.
I have a lady, doctor.
Your name and your hometown?
Gil Gullo, Los Angeles, California.
Gil, what is your last name?
Gullo.
Gallo?
Yes.
And how old are you, Gil?
14 and a half.
You're 14 and one half. All right, Gil. This is for 10 silver dollars. Which of these would you most logically measure in a tablespoon? Uranium, sugar, or tables?
Sugar.
You're right, for 10 silver dollars. Sugar is the right answer. And now let's go over to... Uh-oh. You hear that music? Time now for our phone questions. Our operators have just placed a call to one of you lucky people. And here is Carol Byron to tell us who we're talking to tonight.
Doctor, for our first telephone call, we've gone clear across the nation to Manchester, New Hampshire, 2,796 miles away, to a man who is a great Dr. IQ fan.
Well, happy to hear that. It's Mr.
Fred Lesniak.
Fred Lesniak. Hello there, Mr. Lesniak.
Hello.
Can you hear me pretty good, sir?
Yes, I can.
Well, it's our pleasure to be talking to you. How are you this evening?
Pretty good. You?
Just fine, thank you, sir. Are you a family man up there in Manchester, New Hampshire?
Yes, I am, sir.
Tell me something about your family, children, and what have you. Do you have children, sir?
Yes, one boy, 2.5 years old.
One boy? Well, sir, we're very happy to be talking to you this evening, Mr. Lesniak. And I tell you what, I have a question here which is worth 25 silver dollars. This close to Christmas, could you, by any chance, use 25 silver dollars?
Of course.
Good. All right, Mr. Lesniak, good luck to you on this question. Are you ready for it?
Yes, I am.
Here it is. Before Queen Elizabeth was crowned, what was the name of the crown princess of Great Britain? For 25 silver dollars.
The crown princess?
Yes, sir. Let me repeat the question. Before Queen Elizabeth was crowned, what was the name of the crown princess of Great Britain? 5 seconds, sir. Your answer, sir?
Gee, I'm sorry. I'm afraid I don't know.
Oh, I'm very sorry as well. It was Elizabeth. Before she was queen, she quite naturally was the crown princess. But, sir, let me see. I just happen to notice here you're watching our program on WMUR-TV. Isn't that right?
That's right, sir.
Well, I want to thank you very much, sir, for sending in your card. And even though you did not have the correct answer, look what we do have for you. Carol is coming in here with a beautiful Dr. IQ silver dollar key ring, which we're going to send to you, Mr. Lesniak, with our compliments. Thank you very much for calling in, and a very Merry Christmas to you and your family.
Thanks.
All right, sir. Goodbye.
I know.
There's Mr. Fred Lesniak from Manchester, New Hampshire. If you people at home would like to be called anywhere in the United States, if you answer the question correctly, next week, incidentally, this question or another question will be worth 50 silver dollars. If you'd like to be the one called at home, all you have to do is send a postcard with your name, address, and phone number, too. Dr. IQ, ABC TV, Hollywood 27, California. Your card may be the one selected, and then you can play our game for cash for correct answers. We'll be placing another home call next week. Now, in just one moment, we come to that famous part of our program where I talk next to the lady in the balcony.
Where is my
star? Hi, folks. We're hard at work getting ready for our show. It takes a lot of people to put a show like this together. The cameraman has to keep on his toes because things move pretty fast.
Oh, we have lots of surprises, with wonderful guest stars dropping in every week.
The mic man's going to be mighty important, too, on our show,
because you'll be hearing your favorite songs, old and new.
Oh, and say, about the sets.
Right on the job. We have lots of exciting sets. Well, I think we're about ready. Quiet, everyone. Okay, Patty, take it away.
Hello, I'm Patty Page.
Hello, I'm Patty Page. Oh, and don't forget this dial, because here's where we'll be with a half hour of music, comedy, and wonderful easy fun every week on ABC.
Balcony doctor. Here for her first week from St. Louis, Missouri. She gave up an opera career to become the mother of 9 children. Mrs. Lorraine Gerard.
Well, hello there, Mrs. Gerard.
Hello, Doctor.
May I welcome you as our very first lady in the balcony?
Thank you.
We couldn't find a prettier lady for our first one, I'll tell you that.
Well, thank you very much.
Is it true that you have 9 children?
Well, you're approximately right.
What do you mean?
I have 9 and 5 nights.
Really? Well, congratulations to you. What are the 9 children, boys, girls, or what?
I have 6 boys and 3 girls.
Isn't that wonderful? Mm-hmm. How do they range in age?
Let me see. I have 2 at 11, 9, 8, 6, 5, 3, 2, and 1.
What do you mean you have two at 11? Did you have twins?
Were twins, yes.
Oh, boy. You've had quite a full life. I imagine they keep you kind of busy, don't they?
They keep me hopping. They keep me on my toes.
And now, how about this opera career that Sue told us about? Tell us something about that.
It was in its minor stages, but it was lots of fun. I was with the St. Louis Grand Opera Company. And then I appeared with the Gran Compañía Internacional de Cuba, which sounds very high-sounding.
It sure does.
And it was lots of fun.
Well, I guess you know a lot about opera then, huh?
I have a great love for it.
Well, I have news for you. We don't have one question for you about opera tonight. Not a single
That's
one.
That's just my luck, isn't it?
Well, listen, I want to tell you now, as our lady in the balcony, Mrs. Gerard, you have agreed to come back every week for 4 weeks or until you miss your fifth question. Each night I will ask you 5 questions. Whenever you miss a question, I will turn off. If these are on, yeah. You see, these lights are on. And then every time you miss a question, I turn off one light like this. Now, if you can go 4 weeks without having your fifth light turned off, you will receive all of the money in your jackpot as well as the money in the 4 weeks jackpot, which we're starting off, incidentally, with 100 silver dollars. Now, if you do not complete the 4 weeks, you will receive only half the money in your personal jackpot. The other half will go into the 4 weeks jackpot. Are you ready?
As ready as I will ever be.
Right. Let's hope I don't turn off any of those lights.
Let's hope not.
Let's get to work on that jackpot of yours. Right. Here's your first question. A fine actor who climbed to fame in the Broadway production of The King and I has a first name that sounds like the old English word for Christmas. $9 is yours if you can tell me his name.
His name is Yul Brynner.
You're right for $9, and you're starting off very well, Mrs. Gerard. Of all the many men who have been king of England, only one monarch has willingly given up his throne. $15 is yours if you can tell me his name and number.
I think it was Edward the VII. I may be sixth.
Oh, you should have gone the other way. I'm very sorry. You had to have the name and number. Edward the VIII. But there goes number 5 light. You have 4 more to go.
Alrighty.
Here is question number 3. One of the most famous of all Christmas stories is The Gift of the Magi by O. Henry. Mm-hmm. It's the story of a girl who sold her beautiful long hair in order to buy a Christmas present for her husband. You're familiar with it, aren't
yes.
you? All right. I will give you $17 if you can tell me what gift her husband bought her for Christmas.
She sold her hair for a watch.
Yes.
And he sold his watch to buy her... Oh, dear. Something for her hair.
And what would that be?
Barrette? No. Oh, I can't think of it.
You're so close, and I'm sorry.
Coronet.
No, ma'am, it's a comb.
Comb, all that.
And I
right.
just couldn't give you a hint. I'm very sorry.
I
hate to turn out that light because you were close, but let's see how well you do on the fourth question. $10 will be your reward if you can unscramble the 2 well-known proverbs that I am going to mix up for you. Now, here goes. Let dogs waste haste. Make sleeping lie.
Let sleeping dogs lie.
And?
Haste makes waste.
You're right for $10. Your jackpot is now up to $19. Here's your fifth and final question for $7. In Dickens' famous Christmas Carol, what was the family name of Tiny Tim? Cratchit, Scratchit, or Matchit?
Cratchit.
You're right for $7. Mrs. Gerard? On your first evening, you built your jackpot to $26. The 4 week jackpot is still at 100. So we'll see you next week at the same time. You'll be with us then?
I'll be delighted.
We'll certainly be looking forward to seeing you. Thank you very much,
Thank
Mrs.
You.
Gerard. Thank you,
Good
ma'am.
Night.
I hope you ladies. Hope you ladies at home have been keeping your score, and if you have scored as well or even better than our lady in the balcony, why don't you let us know about it? Give us a bit of your background, if you will, please, and send us a card. Just drop that card to Dr. IQ, KABC-TV, Hollywood 27, California. You may be a very logical candidate for Our Lady in the Balcony. Let's go back now to our audience and Carol Byron.
I have a gentleman, Doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir?
Cecil Moore, Griffin, Georgia.
How do you do, Mr. Moore? This is for $12 within 5 years. How long did it take Daniel Webster to compile the dictionary? 5 seconds, sir.
7 years.
Oh, I'm very sorry, sir. It took Noah Webster 21 years to do it. But we're going to give you a Dr. IQ souvenir silver dollar. Thank you, sir. Over now to Sue England, way back in the back.
I have a gentleman, Doctor.
Your name and your hometown, sir?
Max Korn, Miami Beach, Florida.
All right, Max. It's time now for one of Dr. IQ's most popular features, the biographical portrait, in which I describe a famous person a clue at a time. If you can correctly identify the personality I am describing after the clue is given, I will give you $75. The longer it takes you to identify the personality, the less your reward.
Are you ready for the first clue?
Yes.
All right, sir. I'd like to remind you, you may make a guess after each clue without penalty. Here's your first clue for 75 silver dollars. He was born on November 4th, 1879, in a place called Ulaga, Oklahoma. All right, second clue for 60 silver dollars. At the age of 17, he went to Argentina, where he made $4 a month punching cattle. From there, he went to South Africa and got a job breaking horses for the British during the Boer War.
No.
All right. For number three, 50 silver dollars. At the close of the war, he joined a Wild West show, billing himself as the Cherokee Kid. No luck? Here's your fourth clue for 35 silver dollars. Back in the United States, his first real fame came as a vaudeville performer, combining rope twirling with humorous comment. No coaching, please. 35 silver dollars.
He was the one that went that killed the airplane.
I have to know his name, sir. I'm sorry, I have to go to the next clue. This is for 25 silver dollars. Later, he became well known as a newspaper columnist, a radio star, and a motion picture star. Concentrate. Here is your sixth clue for 15 silver dollars. He expressed his philosophy of life when he said, "I joke about every prominent man of my time, but I never met a man I didn't like." Oh, I wish I could tell you. Here is the seventh clue for 10 silver dollars. He lost his life, as you said, in an airplane crash near Point Barrow, Alaska, on a flight with Wiley Post. Does Wiley Post help to bring it back?
No, I don't remember the name.
Here's your eighth clue for 5 silver dollars. He was known as the Sage of Claremore, Oklahoma. Here's your last clue for 1 silver dollar. His first two names were William Penn, but he was called Will
Rogers.
That's right, for 1 silver dollar. Let's go over now to Carol Byron.
I have a young lady, Doctor.
Your name and your hometown, please.
Ann Gorgeous of Burbank.
All right, Ann, for 10 silver dollars, what does the M stand for in the name of Vice President Richard M. Nixon? Mill Stream, Mill House, or Mill Town? 5 seconds.
Mill House.
You say Mill House? That's right, for 10 silver dollars. Yes, ma'am. Richard, Mill House, Nixon. That signal, ladies and gentlemen, means it's time now for our winner's circle question. My assistants have given each of tonight's winners a card. I want you people to write on that card your name, the amount of money you won, and the answer to the question I'm about to give you. To the person who comes closest to the correct answer, I will double his or her money. Listen to this question. When Elvis Presley was drafted as a $78 a month rookie in the Army, how much money did his manager say it would cost the government in income tax each year? As you're giving us the answer to that question and coming down to our winner's circle, here is something of interest to everyone.
Hi there, this is Peter Lind Hayes.
And this is Mary Healy.
We're inviting you to join us on our show. First of all, we thought we might do something dramatic, then we decided against it because there are so many successful ones.
Oh, John! John, how could you do this to me, John? Oh, John, after all that we meant to each other. Oh, John, 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 John!
What is this, my wife's other John? Anyway, if you're available, I hope you will join us. The format's
pretty rapid. Oh, John! John, it's not true what they say about me, John. It's not true. I'm not a bad woman, John. Tell me I'm not bad. Tell me I'm not bad. Tell me I'm not bad.
You're not very good either. Actually, the format of this...
Oh, John! John, don't look at me that way, John.
You mean there's another way?
John, what are you going to do, John? What are you going to do?
I'm going to do a variety show called the Peter Lind Hayes Show on the ABC television network Monday through Friday. Be there.
Doubled. As soon as we get a seat, sit down and make yourselves comfortable. The question is, when Elvis Presley went into the Army, a $78 a month rookie, how much is this going to cost the government in income taxes? Maybe the government isn't worried, but I'll bet his manager is. Well, you know the correct answer? It's $500,000. In income taxes. In just a moment, we're going to see who's going to get the money. We have this many ties? Look at this. 3 different people. Oh, I see. They did not hit it on the nose, but 3 people said $1 million, and they came the closest. First one won $11. Evelyn Dyer from Washington. Well, who's Evelyn? Evelyn. All right, stand by. Eugene Pucci. All right, just a second, son. I'll get you. Eugene Pucci from Los Angeles. Mr. Pucci is right here. Or no, pardon me. Over there. Don't hide. All right. And here is Leonard Rosenthal Is that you? I'm sorry, son. Evidently, you didn't have a million. All three of you gentlemen are going to get your money doubled. Congratulations to you. Thank you very much. I'm afraid that's all. We'll see you 1 week from now. Till then, I'd like to thank Carol and Sue and everyone who participated on the program. Tom Kennedy, your Dr. IQ, saying see you next week. Goodbye.
Dr. IQ, the Best Banker, has been presented from ABC's Television Center in Hollywood. If you'd like to be called on the telephone at home and win silver dollars for correct answers, send a card to Dr. IQ, ABC TV, Hollywood 27. Once again, from Hollywood, we present Dr. IQ, the Mental Banker. This has been an ABC Television Network presentation. That American bandstand man, Dick Clark, helps Patty Page introduce her two newest recordings. It's musical fun next over ABC Television Network.
Just enough, and if you're greedy enough, maybe some of you, maybe even one of you, could win $2 million. And I wish you the best. I'm going to get started by asking our qualifying question. The five players closest to the correct answer, high or low, will make up our team. And here is your qualifying question. In terms of millions, what is the weekly readership of the national weekly magazine TV Guide? Your time starts now. Well, all of your answers are locked in. The correct answer may surprise you. 35 million people read TV Guide. So with that in mind, who is going to be our captain? That's you, Mark, 38. Very close. Come on over here. You're going to lead this team. Who's the next player? Alan with 45, position number one right over there. Congratulations. Who's our next player? Courtney, number three. Good for you. And who is our next player? Jeff, right over here. Chris, Bill, one of you are going to go back to the contestant pool. One of you will be playing for over $2 million. Let's see who it's going to be now. It's going to be you, Bill. You're playing. Chris, thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your team for greed. Every team has a common foe. Let's take a look at yours. It's called the Tower of Greed. Starts at $25,000. Moves in $25,000 increments right on up to $100,000. Doubles there at $200,000. Moves on to $500,000. Doubles there at $1 million. And then for the grand prize of $2 million. Remember that any team that misses a question loses everything. And Mark, you're going to be the captain. You have a lot of responsibility. You're going to decide just how far you can take your team up the Tower of Greed. You can stop any time after any correct answer and collect the money. You can also reject any answer and replace it with one of your own. So if you're ready, Mark, let's play greed.
Let's do it.
Here we go. All right, Bill, we're going to start off with you, $25,000 question. Before I do that, were you a clown at one time? Is that correct?
Yes, for 7 years I was Snuggles the Clown.
Oh, good. Hey, Bill, you ready for this question?
I'm ready.
$25,000. Here we go. Bill, what pop group sings the Friends theme song? The Van Goghs, the Rembrandts, Picasso's, the Renoir.
I'm fairly certain it's the Rembrandts.
You think it's the Rembrandts? Do you accept or reject that answer, Mark?
I remember the song was very popular, stayed in the top 10 for a long time, and I'm 100% sure it's the Rembrandts. I'm going to accept.
Rembrandts. Going to accept for $25,000. Was it the Rembrandts? That's it. Congratulations. $25,000. You want to keep your $25,000? You want to risk it and go for $50,000?
No, we're going on.
Here we go.
All right.
Hi, Jeff.
Hey, Chuck. How are you?
How are you, Jeff?
Good, thanks.
Now, Jeff, I understand you were related to Curly of the Three Stooges. Is that right?
Just for a very short time. I understand my great aunt was married to him for exactly 10 days. And then they had the marriage annulled. So I guess it wasn't a love connection.
Oh, is that true? Well, yeah. I guess that's true. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you for that little piece of history.
Absolutely.
Jeff.
Sure. Yeah.
All right, Jeff, here is your $50,000 question. What deep-voiced actor proudly proclaims, "This is CNN"? Is it James Earl Jones, Charlton Heston, James Coburn, Sean Connery?
Chuck, I watch a lot of CNN, and I'm sure that it's James Earl Jones.
He's either 90% sure or he's sure. We can't tell. Mark, you want to accept or reject that answer?
That was definitely my pick, so I'm going to accept.
$50,000. Is it James Earl Jones? Thank you. Nicely done, Jeff. Rolling right along. Keep the 50. Risk it. Go for 75. What are you going to do?
We're going to risk it. Let's go on.
Hi, Courtney. How are you, huh?
I'm well. How are you?
Fine. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, too.
Yeah. So, now, you had a close encounter with George Harrison of the Beatles. Is that correct?
Yeah, I did, actually, in a Brown bookstore in Providence, Rhode Island. Oh. I love the Beatles. So here I am staring at this guy thinking, okay, it's Brown graduation weekend. I know you're famous. I just can't remember who you are.
Well, better luck this time. $75,000 on this question, Courtney. Here we go.
All right.
What pop superstar had a reoccurring role on Different Strokes and was a series regular on Good Times? Was it Whitney Houston? Is it Lauryn Hill? Is it Jennifer Lopez? Paula Abdul? Janet Jackson?
Well, I'm going to say that I'm 100% sure that it's Janet Jackson.
Janet Jackson, she says 100%. What do you think, Mark? Accept? Reject?
I know she was on Good Times. I have no idea about Different Strokes, but I'll go with Courtney and I'll accept.
$75,000 on this. Janet Jackson, is that correct?
Yes.
$75,000 in your pocket. Going to go for 100. Feel the need for greed, Mark?
Absolutely. We need the money here.
Here we go. Alan, how are you?
I'm great, Chuck.
Now, I know that all of you are big TV fans. I know that you're a TV fan. How much television do you watch a week?
Way too much.
Do you really?
Probably 10 hours a day.
10 hours a day?
Well, I write about television, so I tell people I'm working, but I'm also having a good time. But I'm working when I'm watching.
Well, that's different. Yeah, 10 hours a day. That's a pretty good day. Well, Alan, I tell you what. $100,000 riding on this. You better know it. Alan, here is your $100,000 question. Good luck. On the classic animated series, The Bullwinkle Show, what was the last name of Boris Badenoch's partner, Natasha? Was it Fatal, Kinski, No Goodnik, Stroganoff, or Goodenough?
I'm taking a guess. But I think it's a good guess. I think it's No Goodnik.
He says No Goodnik, Mark. Except to reject the answer.
Well, I know it's not Kinski, and I know it's not Stroganoff. And my gut was going to be Fatal, but...
You're the captain. You have to do what you think is right.
I know it's not Goodnik either. So right now it's a 50-50 between Fatal and No Goodnik. I'm gonna accept No Goodnik.
Accept No Goodnik for $100,000. Is that correct? Oh. Guess what it was, Mark?
Fatal.
It was Fatal. You had it. You had it all the time. Oh, I'm so sorry. That was not an easy one either. I thought that was very difficult. But you actually had it covered. You just moved on your instincts. I'm so sorry. Sorry, guys. Gonna find another team right after this. Stay with us.
Travel provided by Priceline.com, where you name the price and save on airline tickets, hotel rooms, mortgages, new cars, and more. Visit Priceline on the internet or call 1-800-PRICELINE.
Welcome back to Greed, everybody. Let's meet our next team of TV experts, and here they are.
Nick Orfi.
Califong, New Jersey. Waiter.
Stuart Shostak.
San Francisco, California. Video post-production specialist.
Melanie Johnston.
Orlando, Florida. Pastry chef.
Rick Hunt.
Miami, Florida. Librarian.
Mara Gadd.
Chicago, Illinois. Fundraiser.
Frank Sheftel.
Sherman Oaks, California. Chocolatier.
Welcome, everybody. Let's get started by asking our qualifying question, and here's our question. According to Nielsen Media Research, what percentage of American households had cable television as of May 1999? Your time starts now. Okay, your answers are all locked in. Here's the correct answer. 68, okay, percent. With that in mind, who is our captain? Who's going to lead this team? It's going to be you, Frank, right up here. 68, right on the nose. Very nicely done. Congratulations. Who's our next player? That'd be you, Rick, 74, right over here, position number one. And who is our next player? We've got a tie. Melanie and Mara, right? Mara, who rung in first? You did, Mara. You're in position number two. Excuse me. Mara, Melanie, you'll be right over here. Stuart, Nick, it's down to you two. One's going back to the contestant pool. Another's going to be playing for over $2 million. Who's it going to be? Mick, you're going to be playing Stuart. Thank you for playing our game. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your next team for Greed. All righty. Frank, you got to remember, any team that misses a question, you lose everything. You're the captain. The responsibilities you have, you're going to decide just how far you can take this team up the Tower of Greed. Stop after any correct answer. Keep the cash. You can also reject any answer. Replace it with one of your own. So if you're ready.
I'm ready.
Let's play Greed.
Let's go.
Hi, Mick.
How you doing, Chuck?
I'm fine. How are you?
Fine.
Hey, Mick, Blues Traveler once opened for your band. You obviously had a band. Is that right?
I played in a rock and roll band in college and for a couple years after that. And our big claim to fame was once at a college gig somewhere where there were like four or five bands. They went on first and we went on last.
Mick, here is your $25,000 question. Which character on Frasier is most likely to drink out of the toilet? Would that be Daphne, Niles, Frasier, or Eddie?
Big fan of Frasier. Really no need to extrapolate much on my answer. It's Eddie. He's the dog.
Eddie's the dog, and that would probably be the guy. That's what he says. Frank, you accept or reject?
It's one of my favorite shows also. Eddie is the dog. I will accept that answer.
$25,000. Is Eddie drinking out of the toilet on Frasier? All right, 25 grand you got. Want to keep it?
Oh, no. We got to keep going. Keep going, Chuck.
Hi, Melanie. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Good. Now, you are a pastry chef, correct?
That's correct.
And you want... Well, that's right. Burt Reynolds lives down around Florida there, doesn't he? So you would have made his birthday cake.
Well, actually, I made it in Los Angeles, but I made it yesterday. It's a chocolate mousse cake. And I put happy birthday, Bert, on top.
Well, congratulations to you. And here, Melanie, is your $50,000 question. What current game show host was once a speechwriter for President Nixon? Was it Regis Philbin, Alex Trebek, Maury Povich, and Stein?
I'm not real sure. I think that was before my time. But I'll take a guess and say Regis Philbin.
He says Regis Philbin. Accept or reject, Frank?
Well, he's a good talk show host and a game show host, but he's not a speechwriter. I'm going to have to reject that answer and go with my own. I believe it's Ben Stein. Ben Stein is the correct answer.
Stein. Says Ben Stein. How do you feel about that, Melanie?
I hope he's right.
Okay, so do I. Worth $50,000. Is that correct, Ben Stein, for $50,000? Yes.
Thank you.
$50,000, gonna keep it?
Oh, no, we gotta keep going, Chuck. We're gonna keep going. Let's go for $75,000.
Hi, Mara, how are you?
Hi, good, thank you.
Good. Your favorite television program of all time, what is your favorite? The one you like the best?
Beverly Hills 90210.
Really?
Yes.
Aaron Spelling, yeah.
I'm a huge fan.
Well, here is your $75,000 question, Mara. TV Guide ranked Chuckles Bites the Dust as its all-time favorite TV episode. What series was it from? Cheers, The Mary Tyler Moore Show, Seinfeld, Taxi, All in the Family.
Well, I have to say that I have absolutely no idea. But my gut says to go with All in the Family, so that's what I'm going to go with.
All in the Family. I think, Frank, accept or reject?
Well, I'm going to have to reject that answer. No offense at all. I happen to be a big fan of the show. I saw the episode. It was hysterical. That would be The Mary Tyler Moore Show.
So you know that it's The Mary Tyler Moore Show.
I know that it's The Mary Tyler Moore Show.
That's what he says. For $75,000... is it The Mary Tyler Moore Show? Yes. Look at you. Two times you say it. You got a good captain here, boy. I'm telling you. He's covering you. $75,000, Frank. You're doing a great job. Keep it. Move on.
We got to move on. We got to go up. I got faith in Rick.
Okay, Rick. How are you?
Great, Chuck. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you. How many hours of television do you watch a day, Rick?
Oh, two or three, maybe.
Yeah, any favorites? Any favorite television?
Fawlty Towers, absolutely.
Love Fawlty Towers.
Classic.
Well, this is not about Fawlty Towers, but it is a $100,000 question, Rick.
Let's do
and here it.
It
is. Which of the following was not a reoccurring sketch on In Living Color? Homie the Clown, Men on Film, Fire Marshal Bill, Homeboy Shopping Network, and Mr. Robinson's Neighborhood.
Well, I watched In Living Color a lot, and I also watched Saturday Night Live a lot, and I know that Mr. Robinson's Neighborhood was on Saturday Night Live, so I'll say Mr. Robinson's Neighborhood.
Accept or reject, Frank?
Well, I also watch this a lot. I have faith in Rick, and I will accept that answer.
All right. Not a recurring sketch on In Living Color. Mr. Robinson's Neighbor. Is that worth $100,000? Very nice enough. They are four questions away from $2 million. We'll be back.
Two and two.
Welcome back to Greed, everybody. We're here with Mick, Melanie, Mara, Rick, and their captain, Frank. And, I was reading a little piece on you, Frank. You actually worked at the chocolate factory that Lucy did that very famous...
What was that yes, like? Yes, the episode. It was great. It was fabulous. I'm a chocolatier, and I was vice president of this company. And on the walls, they have all the pictures of Lucy and Ethel with all the chocolate. It was really fun.
That's a great moment.
It was a great one of my favorite episodes.
I'll bet. Well, you're just four questions away from $2 million, by the way. I should mention that in this round, the questions get a little harder. Each question has four correct answers. You're going to be depending on your teammates to come up with those answers, Frank. And
yes.
So now I'm going to ask you, do you want to keep that $100,000 or do you want to risk it on $200,000? Before you answer that question, let me tell you what the category for your $200,000 question is. The category is MTV.
MTV. Okay.
Now, keep the $100,000.
I think we're going to go for it.
The sound of the Terminator. It gives one player a chance to eliminate another player and take all their money by challenging them to a one-question showdown. Or they can keep the team the way it is. But to sweeten the pot, I'm going to give the challenger $10,000 for the showdown, win or lose. So let's activate the Terminator now. Melanie. Melanie, the Terminator has chosen you. Is there anyone here that you would like to call out and challenge for $10,000, win or lose?
Well, the show is called Greed, so I'm going to call out Mara.
Come on, Mara. Here we go.
All right,
you'll be here. Melanie, you'll be here. Here's your $10,000, win or lose. And I'm going to ask you one question. You can buzz in anytime you think you know the answer. The winner will be playing for $80,000. The loser is out of the game. Okay? Good luck to both of you. Here's your question. Before winning two Academy Awards for directing, who directed the first regular series episode of Columbo? Yes, Mara?
Clint Eastwood.
No, I'm sorry. It was Steven Spielberg. But nice try. Those were not easy. Well, congratulations, Melly. You got your money. Thank you, Mara. Melly's going to be playing for $80,000. Everybody else playing for $40,000. And here is your $200,000 question. I said the category was MTV. Which four of the following six were original DJs on MTV? Alan Hunter, Downtown Julie Brown, Wolfman Jack, Martha Quinn, J.J. Jackson, Mark Goodman. Now, since your team's gotten this far, you've earned a freebie. You can remove one wrong choice from any question from here on out. It's up to you. Use it now. You want to save it.
Well, you know, I'm not much of an MTV watcher. This is a fairly good category for me, but I'm not real confident, so I think I'm going to use the freebie.
Okay, use the freebie now. Take away one wrong answer. It would be Downtown Julie Brown. So, Mick, you're first up. Give me a correct answer.
Mark Goodman was the original DJ.
Goodman. DJ. Melanie?
Well, I'm definitely confident about one. I'm going to say Martha Quinn.
Martha Quinn. Rick?
I'm absolutely positive that Alan Hunter was one of the original DJs.
So far, all your teammates are very positive with their answers. How about you, Frank?
Well, I'm going to have to go with J.J. Jackson.
Okay. As captain, you can change any one answer that you feel you should change. Or leave them the way they are. It's up to you.
You know, I feel pretty confident with these answers. I'm going to let it ride. I'm gonna keep them all.
Okay. $200,000. Alan Hunter, is that correct? Goodman. That's three. That sound means I offer you money. Frank, let me get the sleeve off this so we can just unroll it and see what it feels. You know, it's so new that it literally sticks together. But anyway,
here
it is. Oh, sure. $20,000. Here's the rest of it. You want to put that in your hand, too. Now, I don't know how sure you are of J.J. Jackson, but just in case you're not too sure of it, this would mean that you'd go home with a little something. Okay?
A little something.
A little something. Well, it's $5,000.
That's absolutely. That's not shabby.
But anyway, depends on how confident you are in J.J. Jackson, or you may be going home with $40,000 or even more if you continue to go on. So it's up to you, Frank.
You know, I think I'm going to go on. I'm going to give you back the money.
J.J. Jackson. $200,000, J.J. Jackson, is it correct? And she's right! Way to go, Melanie. All right, $200,000, three questions away. Watch our TV experts climb that tower of greed in just a moment. We'll be back. Welcome back to Greed, everybody. Mick's got $40,000. Melanie, she's got $80,000. Frank has $40,000. And, Rick has $40,000. And Frank also has $40,000. So you're $200,000 richer. You want to keep the $200,000? You want to risk it for the $500,000? Before you answer, Frank, let me tell you what the category for the $500,000 question is. Animated characters. Now, keep the $200,000.
No. You know, I think I'm gonna have to stop here. It's a lot of money.
Congratulations, Frank. She's got, Melanie is thrilled. She's got $80,000. Everybody else has 40. Go down there and meet your team. Nicely done. All right, let's meet our next team of TV experts.
Daryl Curtin,
Brooklyn, New York, financial writer.
Mike Wallace,
Atlanta, Georgia, researcher.
Peter Field.
Los Angeles, California, documentarian.
Dennis Bailey.
Grosse Pointe, Michigan, author.
Melanie Dark.
Cherry Valley, California, project coordinator.
Carrie Nicholson.
Hoboken, New Jersey, media planner.
Welcome, everybody. Let's get started by asking our qualifying question. Here it is. As of today, how many Emmy nominations has Sesame Street received? Your time starts now. Okay, your answers are locked in. The correct number is Emmys. Boy, this is a lot of nominations. 192. Can you believe that? Well, let's see who came closest. They'll be our captain. Let's see who it's going to be. It's going to be you, Daryl, with 99. Congratulations, right over here. You'll be leading this team. I always like it when the captain looks absolutely shocked and surprised. Who's our next player? That's you, Carrie, right over here. Congratulations. And who's next? Congratulations, Melanie. You're next. And who's our next player? Peter, right over here, Peter. Well, it's down to Mike and Dennis. One's going to go back in the contestant pool. One will be playing for over $2 million. Who's it going to be? It's going to be you, Dennis. Congratulations, Mike. Maybe we'll see you in another game. Thank you. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your next team for Greed. All right. So, okay, Dennis, you're the fifth-ranked player. Welcome to the game.
Thank you, Chuck.
Nice to have you here. You're a writer, that's correct?
Yes, sir.
What kind of things do you write about?
I actually have a book which is being published by Bantam. It's out in August. I've written it with David Mixner. It's called Brave Journeys.
Congratulations,
Thank
Dennis.
Thank you, sir.
And here, sir, is your $25,000 question. Which of the following shows did not feature yours truly, Chuck Woolery, as a regular host? Love Connection, Scrabble, Wheel of Fortune, Singled Out.
I am pretty sure about this. Chuck, I've been following your career.
Well, let's see. We'll just see, Dennis.
I'm going to say the one that you did not regularly host was Wheel of Fortune.
Okay. Daryl, would you accept or reject that answer?
I'd have to agree.
Have to agree. Wheel of Fortune is the one. Okay. Well, $25,000. Is it Wheel of Fortune? Well,
what?
The shortest. You have a congratulations.
Oh my God.
The shortest. The team that lasted the shortest of anybody in the history of Greed on my question. Of course, it would be me. I did Wheel of Fortune. I didn't do Singled Out. We're going to take a commercial. We're going to meet a brand new team that knows a little bit more about me right after this. Stay with us.
And 30 Central, Fox Monday.
Welcome back to Greed, everybody. I must say that I'm a little hurt, especially because he's followed my career so closely. But anyway, let's meet our new team for Greed.
Richard Riley.
Santa Monica, California, small aircraft manufacturer.
Stuart Shostak.
San Francisco, California, video post-production specialist.
Samantha Nixon.
Las Vegas, Nevada, real estate agent.
Courtney Potter.
Los Angeles, California, production assistant.
Kenneth Hale.
Chicago, Illinois, music producer.
Chris Quiroz.
Roland Heights, California, operations analyst.
All right, welcome everybody. Let's get started by asking our qualifying question, and here is your question. According to their statistics, how many criminals has the show America's Most Wanted captured as of today? Your time starts now. Okay, your answers are all locked in. I want you to listen to this. These are hardened criminals they caught. 599. Can you believe that? Well, let's find out who our captain's gonna be. It's gonna be you, Samantha. 450. That's pretty good. Right over here, you're gonna be leading this team. Who's next? You're gonna be next, Chris. Right over here. Who is our next player? That'll be you, Courtney. Right over here. We got three women right in a row. Okay, guys, who's next? That'll be you, Richard, right here. And between Stuart and Ken, one's gonna play for $2 million. The other one's gonna go back in the contestant pool. Who's gonna play? You're gonna play, Stuart, believe it or not. Ken, thank you very much. Stuart's very excited. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your next Game for Greed. Samantha, I got to remind you, anytime a team misses a question, they lose everything. We've seen a lot of people lose everything. So, I don't know, maybe you ought to stop at $25,000. I don't want to guide you through this. You've got a lot of responsibility. You're going to decide just how far you can take your team up the Tower of Greed. You can stop after any correct answer and keep the cash. You can also reject any answer and replace it with one of your own. Okie doke, you're ready. Let's play Greed. Hey, Stuart, how are you?
Good, Chuck. How are you doing?
Fine, thank you. Now, you collect vintage television shows. Tell me a little bit more about that.
Well, I started when I was about 10 or 11. I started with 8mm films and worked my way into 16mm when I could afford it. And then when video came out, that really made it real easy for me. And I've got close to 7,000 shows in my library.
Wow, are these worth money? I mean, are they worth anything?
I don't know, but
you'll
I wish
find
I
out someday.
This is worth money here.
Yeah, this is worth money. As a matter of fact, Stuart, it's worth $25,000. Here's your question. Which part of her anatomy did Entertainment Tonight's Mary Hart ensure with Lloyd's of London? Her legs, her smile, her hair, her eyes.
Well, my biggest fear was telling you that I had this enormous TV collection and then not knowing the question.
I hope you know it.
I happen to know that it's her legs.
He says her legs. You agree, Samantha?
I absolutely agree. I'm
going to accept that answer.
I accept.
$25,000. Her legs. Is it correct? $25,000. You feeling lucky, Samantha?
I'm feeling lucky.
You got past that $25,000 hurdle. You going to move on?
Yes.
Absolutely. All right. Hey, Richard, how are you?
Doing good.
Now, Richard, you breed roses, right?
I do.
Yeah. How do you get them in the mood? I mean, when they get a little thorny. What goes on?
A little bit of romantic music. I talk dirty to them.
Oh, yeah. What do you say to them, Richard?
No. Hey, baby.
Okay. All right. All right. Okay, I'm not going to get past the... I almost said the thorny thing again, but I won't do it. Okay, Richard, here is your $50,000 question. To Serve Man and A Stop at Willoughby were classic episodes of what long-running TV series? Alfred Hitchcock's Presents, The Outer Limits, Playhouse 90, The Twilight Zone.
I'm absolutely certain that it's the Twilight Zone.
Samantha, he seems pretty secure.
I'm going to trust him on that. I'll accept that
answer. You're not real sure?
I'm going to trust him on that one, yes.
Accepting that answer, is it the Twilight Zone? Yes. Yes. You know, it's funny. I remember To Serve Man. I remember that. It was all about how to cook them, wasn't it? It was a... Well, never mind. It was
outer
space. It was. Yeah. Got $50,000. So you're going to keep that? You're going to move on.
We are going for it.
$75,000 to you, Courtney. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. Now, you come from a musical family. Tell me a little bit about that.
My dad is a songwriter and producer, and in the 70s, he was nominated for a couple Grammys. And
was he really? On what? Yeah. What were the songs?
He was nominated for the Glen Campbell album, Rhinestone Cowboy.
Oh, yeah, sure. And he wrote some of those.
Yeah, he did.
Well, I'll be daggum. Well, Courtney, here is your $75,000 question. Good luck.
Thanks.
Steve Van Zandt of Bruce Springsteen's E Street Band has a prominent role in what TV series? ER, The Sopranos, The Practice, NYPD Blue, Veronica's Closet.
Well, I like this show a lot. I have watched it many times, and I am certain that Steve Van Zandt is on The Sopranos.
Samantha, accept or reject?
I accept that answer.
$75,000. Is it The Sopranos? Go for 100?
Yes.
Do you feel the need?
I feel the need.
worried.
Atta girl, here we go. How you doing, Chris?
I'm good, Chuck. How are you?
I'm fine. Now, you once shared a plane ride with some of the cast of the Hill Street Blues, right?
That's correct.
Now, what was that about? Were you on a private plane or?
No, I was on a flight en route to Acapulco and from Los Angeles to Dallas. I was on the flight with Dennis Franz, James B. Sicking, and Charles Haight.
Oh, well, that's great. Well, here is your $100,000 question. The creator of Beavis and Butthead also created what current primetime hit? South Park, Futurama, King of the Hill, Malcolm in the Middle, Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
It's one of my favorite shows. Love to watch it. It's King of the Hill.
King of the Hill, she says.
It's one of my favorite shows, too, so I do agree.
Get up. $100,000. Is it King of the Hill? Four questions away. We'll be right back. See how they do. Stay with us.
Travel provided by Priceline.com, where you name the price and save on airline tickets, hotel rooms, mortgages, new cars, and more. Visit Priceline on the internet or call 1-800-PRICELINE.
Greet everybody. We're here with Stuart, Richard, Courtney, and Chris, and their captain Samantha. You guys are doing great. Four questions away from $2 million. Your dad played professional baseball for who?
He played for the Cleveland Indians, the Minnesota Twins, and the Boston Red Sox.
Did he? What position?
He was a catcher.
Is that right?
And he actually was the catcher when Roger Maris hit his 61st home run.
Oh my gosh. Well, that's crazy. Well, Samantha, in this round, let me remind you that the questions get a little bit harder. Each question has four correct answers. You'll be depending on your teammates to come up with those answers. And before you figure out or answer me whether you want to keep that $100,000 or you want to risk it, let me tell you what the category of your $200,000 question is. It's news magazines. Now, do you want to keep the $100,000 or do you feel the need to do
it? I'm going to go for it. We're going to go
for
it.
Stuart, the Terminator has chosen you. Is there anyone here that you'd like to choose and challenge for $10,000, win or lose?
My second biggest fear, besides not knowing the first question. You know, if this was a regular game of greed, when it was where it was general knowledge,
yes,
I'd have a different answer. But I think we've got a heck of a good team here. I want to keep it the way it is for
keep
now.
Keep it the way it is. Here we go. Go for the $200,000. Right. Stuart realizing if he'd won, he would be playing for $80,000. But here we go. Let's take a look and see what's going to happen. Everybody's playing for $40,000. Here is your $200,000 question. Good luck to all of you. Which four of the following six have been regular correspondents on the Sunday edition of 60 Minutes? Diane Sawyer, Meredith Vieira, Bernard Shaw, Leslie Stahl, Dan Rather, Chris Wallace. Now, since you've come this far, your team has earned this freebie. It's good to take away one wrong answer from any question here on out. If you want to use it now, you use it later.
I'm going to use it now.
Use it now. Okay. Best four out of five. And there goes Chris Wallace. So, Stuart.
Well, this wasn't as hard as I thought it was going to be. Diane Sawyer.
Definitely. One. Richard.
Leslie Stahl.
That's two. Courtney.
I'm going to have to say Meredith Vieira.
That's three.
The old standard.
Chris.
Dan Rather.
That's four. Samantha, you're the captain. Now, is there anything there that you want to change? Are you happy with those four choices? Or do you see perhaps that you can change it to make it correct? Anyway.
Let's see. One left that I thought might not be the right answer, but I'm not sure. I think we have a good team. I'm going to stick with the answers that are there.
$200,000. Is Dan Rather correct? It is. Diane Sawyer. She was on 60 Minutes. Sunday 60 Minutes. Say yes. Yes, she was. Leslie Stahl. Sunday version of 60 Minutes. Yes. Well, it's like Meredith. It's down to Meredith, isn't it? I don't know whether you know this or not or feel comfortable. I'm just going to offer you $20,000. It's $5,000 apiece, just in case you're not that sure. And here's the money. I'll let you hold it. It's $4,000 each. What did I say, five?
Yeah,
higher math was never my strong suit. You can hold on to that, weigh it. If you want to give it back to me, you can, and try for the $200,000, or you can give them that money. It depends on what you want to do.
I'm going to stick with our choices.
You're going to give me the money back, aren't you?
Give it back.
You're not sure, are you?
No, I'm not.
You're not sure. So it takes a little courage to do this, doesn't it?
It takes a lot of courage.
Because if you're wrong, they're all going to be mad at you.
Yes, they are.
If they're right, you're going to be their new best friend.
I am. Let's hope so.
How about Meredith? Is she there? Meredith Vieira? $200,000. What's your dad's name? I never asked you. Can you remember now after all this excitement?
Russ Nixon.
Russ Nixon. Okay, good. Well, Russ, she's got 40,000. Everybody up here has got 40K. Well, you want to keep the 200,000 or go for the 500,000? It's kind of tough to answer that question right now, so take a breath. I'm going to give you the category to the $500,000 question. Here it is. TV memorabilia. Keep the 200.
Over there. I'm sitting here.
Well, that's one out of four.
That's one out of four. You know what? We are going to stop.
We're going to stop.
We're going to stop.
Oh, they're happy. Look at them. They got all their money. Come on down here and meet your team. Come on. You've let them all the $40,000. Come on, you guys. Congratulations to all of you. We've had a great TV Greed. We're going to be back next Friday at our regular time with another episode of Greed. But first, be sure to tune in next Monday and Tuesday for a special version of that 70s Greed right here on Fox. Good night, everybody.
KOFY Coffee, TV 20, San Francisco.
And now, a game of high stakes, where every decision is a gamble and every move could be your last.
Much, everybody, and welcome to High Roller, skill, strategy, sabotage, and these unpredictable dice. They're the elements we have for you as our players try to win prizes totaling over $17,000 that we're about to put on our game board. And that's just our first game with a lot to follow after that in ensuing games. Then whoever wins a 2 out of 3 game match goes on to play the big numbers for $10,000 in cash. And it could happen to one of these lucky people. Say hello to Mona Leek from Oak Ridge, Tennessee. She is our current challenger. She's a homemaker and a volunteer. You worked for Easter Seals for a long time, didn't you?
Right.
How many years?
I was a volunteer with Easter Seals for 14 years. I served as president for two consecutive years.
That's great work.
And we do great work for the handicapped
and
children and adults.
And you're good work here with these dice, too, by the way. Congratulations on both counts. You have $12,680 so far as our challenger. Say hello to our champion over here, Richard Harrison from Tucson, Arizona. Richard, with $10,050 so far. He's a jingle writer who enjoys scuba diving, and I understand you do a lot of underwater photography, eh?
I sure do. When I find time, I like to go to Mexico. I was scuba diving in the Caribbean.
It's easy for you to say.
Yeah.
Hey, Richard, welcome back. On our last show, each of you won a game. This is the tiebreaker. And, of course, for a new game, the final game in this match, we need prizes. We have some good ones, too. Take a look. Dean Goss, what do we have in column one?
This collection, crafted by skilled artisans, is fashioned from fossilized stones, indigenous to the South Pacific. Color variations and other markings are natural features, furnished by Artisan Collection. And add this to your collection. It's Kremen's Jewelry's 14-karat yellow gold pendant, designed with three genuine emeralds and two full-cut diamonds, furnished by Kremen's Jewelry. This jeweled column has a value of $1,350.
Let's go to the center column and see what Dean had for us there.
The combining of two art forms can be found in great detail in these Chinese figurines. Ivory-headed hands and cloisonné bodies, furnished by Barons Melrose. These lovely ladies will look perfect in this hand-painted, lacquered-finished curio cabinet, featuring glass shelves and pagoda top, furnished by Palsai Furniture Manufacturer. It gives the column a value of $2,980.
And finally, in column three, Dean, what do we find?
It's a high roller's version of a romp of the races called Dice Derby, where one roll of the die could give you a sure bet worth $1,000, or an even better bet, a brand new car! This car is the MX6 Sport Coupe. It comes standard with a 2.2-liter overhead cam engine, patented independent rear suspension, plus many luxury features. Furnished by Mazda, it gives the column a potential value of $13,425 and the potential game a value of $17,755.
Let's see the numbers now. Here they come, lined up for us. Hot column for this game, players. Column 3, meaning a roll of a 12, gives you a chance at the Dice Derby game and a possible car worth over $13,000 is that column. Here's your first question, players. If I said you had met your Waterloo, would it mean you'd had a victory or suffered a defeat? Richard?
Suffered a defeat.
Yeah, Waterloo. Let's see if you can win this final game.
Coming out. Let's go.
Our champion.
Let me get a 12. Box
each of you have a game of peace. What is your roll?
Let's go.
6 and 4.
6 and 4.
10.
Let me take the 1, 2, 3, and 4.
1, 2, 3, and 4. All righty. Here's your next question. If you practice monotheism, do you believe in having one wife or one God? Richard?
One God.
One God. Monotheism, yes. Pick them up, Richard. Bad roll. 3, 4, and 10. You want to roll them or give them to Mona?
I'm going to give them to Mona.
Mona, you roll them. Yep. The match is at stake.
Oh,
3, 4, and 10. Stay away from those three.
She had left 7.
For the Dice Derby game, does she come up with it? 8.
8.
Good roll, though.
I'll take 8.
All right, 8 in column 2. You got it. You hear the word space, the final frontier. Are you watching Star Wars? All right, Richard.
Star Trek.
You got it.
Yeah.
Star Trek. That's what you'd be watching. Now, what do you want to do, Richard? Roll them or give them to her?
Ladies first.
I think if he gave them to you last time, he's going to give them to you this time. Mona, the good rolls are 5, 6, 7, 9, 11, and 12.
All right, give me that 7.
The match is at stake. She'd love to play Dice Derby. She has rolled a 10, and that's a bad roll. And Richard, you continue as our champion. Well, congratulations again, Richard. Let's see, you picked up totals thus far of $10,150, $100 for that game, and the right to go up against the big numbers in just a moment for an additional $10,000. Well, Mona, you played a good game. You leave us hardly empty-handed. $12,680 as you go back to
Tennessee. Fantastic. Thank you
very much.
Delighted
to meet you.
Thank you.
Give all our friends in Tennessee hello.
I sure will. Bye-bye. Thank you,
Mona.
Good luck, Richard.
Richard, we're going to put the spotlight on you now, as you know, to play the big numbers for a chance of $10,000 in cold hard cash. Here comes Casey with the golden dice. Take a look at those. Talk to them for a moment while we take a commercial break. We'll talk to the folks about some good products, pay a few bills, and we'll be right back to see if you can win 10 grand. Don't go away, everybody.
It's on sale now.
Now back to High Rollers and Wink.
Richard, with $10,150, you have the chance to add to that by a considerable margin now, as you have a chance to knock off these nine numbers. $100 a number, but get them all off. I'll pay you $10,000 in cash. And you know that these ever-present insurance markers are here. Before a double, this can get you out of trouble, meaning if you throw a number that can't be made, you get a free roll. You know that. So let's get started,
all
Richard.
Right.
Talk to those dice and bring them
all
on
right,
home.
Let's
please.
Go. Let's go.
Here we go.
Let's
10
go.
Grand.
Pick them.
And his first roll is an 8.
I'll take the 8.
All right. It all comes to Big Orange. Right. 8. You have $100 in your pocket, Richard.
Okay. All right. All right.
$10,000
at stake. Big numbers. Let's go.
5.
5. I'll take the 5.
All right. All comes to 5. People get so near and yet so far sometimes.
Okay. All right. Let's go for double.
$200 so far. There's a double. Yeah. 4 the hard way. Hard way 4. There you go.
I'll take the 4, please.
All right, off comes the 4, leading to 1, 2, 3, 6, 7, 9, and all the combinations in between. Richard.
Doubles again.
9.
I'll take the 9.
All right, off comes the 9. Yeah, got rid of that big pesky 9 there.
Gotcha.
Richard, you're up to $400, reaching for $10,000.
All right, magic dice.
Double,
only good numbers.
2 and a 4.
The 6. I'll take the 6.
Off comes the 6. Yeah. All righty, Richard. 1, 2, 3, 7.
Okay, 4 left. Let's go.
He has rolled a 5. You can do it.
I'll take the 3 and the 2.
3 and the 2 come off, leaving only the 7 and the 1. How about an 8 the hard way? Hard way 8. You got 1 insurance marker. 7 and 1. 4 and 4. 5 and 3.
Let's go. 8.
How about an 8 for $10,000? Does
eight,
he do it?
8.
6. And you can't do it. So I'm going to have to take that insurance marker. So now you need either an eight or a double. Richard, we're pulling for you. Come on.
All right.
$700 so far. $10,000.
Right. Let's go. One
if you
time.
Can make an 8.
One time for the family. Let's
How about
go.
Eight. Double. 6. You get another roll. Let's bring them back. Gives you an insurance marker, but you need to roll that right now. Come on, Richard. 8.
Eight.
Everybody
eight.
Wants
eight.
To see
eight.
You do it.
Eight.
Everybody
eight.
Wants you to win.
Eight.
Me.
Eight. Eight. Eight.
Do it. 5. No, he doesn't do it. Leaving the 7 and the 1 up there, Richard. Boy, it seems so easy. It looks easy, doesn't it? So you added, what, $700 to your score, taking you up to $10,850 total. You're still the champ and about to meet a brand new challenger right now. Everybody say hello to Janine Jackson, originally from Richmond, Virginia.
Hi.
Shake hands with our champion over here, Janine. By the way, Janine, if she looks familiar, is a returning contestant, and in always an effort to be fair, we made a mistake when she was here before, so she's back to give it another roll. Janine, welcome
Thank
to
you.
Our show.
Thanks.
Janine, if I remember right, you're a party manager for a catering company, right?
That's exactly right.
Well, I know you're glad to be back, and we're glad to have
I
you here,
am.
Too. All right, so let's get going. You know Janine from past experience, and as does Richard, we need prizes to start a new match, and here they come. In column one, Dean Goss, what do we have?
It's a complete kitchen. A tap-in kitchen featuring side-by-side refrigerator that contains chilled water dispenser and automatic ice maker. Plus, an electric range with self-cleaning oven and a big microwave oven on top. Then a heavy-duty built-in dishwasher with 2 stainless steel revolving arms and 10 timer selections. And lastly, a trash compactor that compresses trash to 1/4 its normal volume. All furnished by Tappan and valued at $3,440.
And moving right next door in column 2.
It's Sopper Furs of Beverly Hills striped muskrat jacket. Should turn any evening into a special event. Traditional quality with new styles by a top designer. Furnished by Sopper Furs of Beverly Hills. And now you're ready to take off to Zurich, Switzerland. We'll fly you aboard a giant jet where you may enjoy the comfort and in-flight services of Northwest Airlines. There you'll spend a week at the Hotel Zurich, a modern deluxe hotel in the heart of Zurich on the Lameau River. Featuring indoor swimming pool, fitness club, and shopping arcade. Enjoy Swiss hospitality furnished by Hotel Zurich. It gives the column a value of $7,020.
Let's don't stop till we finish in column 3.
It's a 6-day houseboat vacation for 10 people at Lake Mead. You'll relax with all the conveniences of home. Enjoy clear water, clean air, and quiet wilderness. A memorable houseboat vacation furnished by Seven Crown Resorts. And for additional fun in the water, it's the Addictor 245 Deluxe Quarter Pounder Boat. Give this boat a chance. You'll be amazed by its spectacular performance. All components are state-of-the-art, top quality. Furnished by Addictor Boats, it gives the column a value of $7,513 and a board value of $17,973.
Sounds good to me. Here come the numbers. You got to deal with these. Hot column for the game, everybody's column one, meaning a roll of a 10 will give you a complete kitchen worth $3,440. However, we're going to take a commercial break. We'll be back as we continue with a new match between Janine and Richard right after this.
And six, 3,800.
Okay, we got the prizes, we got the numbers up there, and here we go. The first question in this new match. Who's married to Gilda Radner? Is it Gene Wilder, Robin Williams, or David Letterman? How about it, Janine?
Gene Wilder.
You got it. Gilda Radner and Gene Wilder. Take these wild dice and give them a roll, Janine.
All right, wild dice. I'm going
to
go to Jared.
Talk to those dice. Be good at it. Four and six.
Ten.
How about a ten?
Okay. I'm going to take the 6, 1, and the 3.
6, 1, and the 3. So be it. Leaving only the 9 in column 2. According to the Book of Health, will you probably burn off more calories making love for an hour or shoveling snow for an hour? Richard?
Shoveling snow for an hour.
You got it. Shoveling snow. Yeah, that takes all sorts of calories. Now, what do you want to do? Only a 3 is a bad roll.
Only a 3.
You want to roll them or give them to Janine?
I'm going to pass.
All right, Janine, he must feel like you're going to roll the 3. Let's see if it happens. Stay away from that 3.
I want to go to Zurich.
First game
9.
It's 7.
7. I'll take a 5 and a 2.
5 and a 2. All right, that clears column 1. You got the kitchen. Can you use that? We're at $3,440.
I don't cook much, but sure.
You can use. You'll find a way to use it if you win the game. What's the difference between a hog and a pig? Is it age, sex, or size? Richard.
Size.
No age. Difference between a hog and a pig? Probably nobody's ever asked you that before. All right, Janine, the bad rolls are 3, 5, 6, and 10. What do you want to do? Roll over, give them to Richard.
Richard, you're a nice guy, and I'm going to...
She returns the favor, Richard. She lets you roll. 3, 5, 6, or 10. Stay away from them. They're bad rolls. Give me a 9.
Give me a 9.
It's 11-9 to clear column 2 for that Zurich trip.
9.
Comes up with a...
No!
He got it.
Yes!
Big column 2.
Give me a 9, please.
All right, that gives you the trip to Zurich and the beautiful fox fur worth over $7,000 if you win the game. Desdemona or Katharina? Who was Othello's beautiful and... All right, Janine?
Desdemona.
Desdemona was Othello's beautiful and faithful wife. Pick him up, Janine. Good rolls for 4, 7, 8, 11, and 12. You want to roll them or give them to him?
No, Richard, hi.
Richard, you get to roll again. Hey, listen, you pulled off a 9 last time.
Yep.
You
can, I can do it. I can do it. I can do it.
Column 3.
Any good number. Any good number. Any good number. An 8. I'll take the 8.
That's a good roll. I'll take the 8. All right, a 7 and a 4. Boy, an 11 would be a good roll next time, wouldn't it? Who usually looks more alike, fraternal twins or identical twins? Richard?
Identical twins.
You got it. All right. They look more alike. What do you want to do with the dice, Richard? Janine, you get the dice.
All right.
The good rolls are 4, 7, and 11. 4, 7, and 11.
Come on. I want an 11.
7 and 4 for a boat and houseboat trip. Does she do it? It's a 7. She does it. And off comes the 7, leaving only the 4 in column 3 for the boat and houseboat. In mythology, did everything that King Midas touched turn to bad luck? Or Richard?
Gold.
Gold is right. Yes, everything turned to gold. All right, only one good roll. You know what that is.
I am going to pass.
Nobody has an insurance marker, Janine. You got to roll a 4 or a double to stay alive in this game. You
all
need
right,
a 4.
All right, come
roll
on,
a 4 and you get a kitchen.
Come on, 4.
Did she do it? 7. No. King goes to Richard. Well, that was a good hot game between you two. Richard came out on top. You picked up Richard by winning that, the beautiful fox fur, the trip to Zurich, Switzerland. Added to your prior winnings, your total now, Richard, is $17,870. Of that, $6,700 is in cash. However, Janine is still smiling because she knows that it takes 2 out of 3 to win a match. You're still very much alive. So let's go on to the next game, shall we? And for that, we need prizes. Dean, take a look at column 1 with us and tell us what we find.
It's the It Takes Two game, where with a couple of rolls of the die, you can win the Wrangler. Continuing the tradition that made the Jeep a legend, this open-air model features room for 4 and offers personal control, comfort, and the flexibility to enjoy both on- and off-road driving. Furnished by Jeep Corporation, which brings the potential value of this column up to $12,680.
And in the middle column, Sir Goss.
You'll be ready to hit the slopes and attack the moguls with these high-quality skis and bindings. And to complete your skiing needs and ensure a fun outing, it's these ski poles, all furnished by Herman Sporting Goods. Now, let's go skiing for 4 days to historic Telluride, Colorado. Enjoy the blue skies, snow-capped peaks, and gold-blatant history of the Rocky Mountains. We'll fly 4 of you to Colorado aboard a giant jet. where you may enjoy the comfort and in-flight services of Continental Airlines. Now thrill to skiing on Colorado's powdery snow when you stay at the Viking Suite Hotel, set in the rugged and beautiful San Juan Mountain Range. The vacation package brings the value of this column to $5,890.
And let's not forget column three. Here we go.
Furnished by Charles & Charles, this imported antique European stove has warmed many hearts over the years on cold winter nights. And it holds two tickets for you to fly to London. Aboard a giant jet where you may enjoy the comfort and in-flight services of Northwest Airlines. You'll see the best of Great Britain as BritRail takes you on the seven-night Great Britain Express Tour, which includes Plymouth, the Cotswolds, a cruise on Lake Windermere, a Scottish Highland supper, and the farewell dinner at an elegant stately home. Furnished by BritRail, it gives the column a value of $6,449 and the board an entire value of $25,019.
Ooh, and that's only for this game with much more to follow. Here are the way the numbers line up for game two. Hot column for this game, Janine and Richard, is column one, meaning a roll of an 11 will give you the chance to play It Takes Two for over $12,000. We're going to take a commercial break, and we promise to be right back.
I don't want to be the biggest, just the best.
If you'd like to be a contestant on High Rollers and you're going to be in the Los Angeles area, please call 213-852-4121 between 10 a.m. and 5 p.m. Pacific time. And now back to more of High Rollers and Wink Martindale.
Richard has the first game. Janine, you need this one to even things up. To get control of the dice, answer this, yes or no. Just answer yes or no. Did Princess Diana of England graduate from the American equivalent of high school? How about it, Diana? Janine?
Yes.
No, she didn't. Oddly enough, no, she did not. Don't you touch those dice, Janine. Yeah, Richard, they're yours. All right, everything's good. Here we go. Scared Janine to death here.
Coming out. Right, let's go for 11. 11. One time. 11. 11.
And
let's go. 11.
We got a 7.
7. I'll take the one, the 2 and the 5 first.
All right, the 2 and the 5. One in column 1, one in column 2. According to George Bernard Shaw, what is it that's such a wonderful thing, it's a crime to waste it on children? Television, youth, or education? Janine.
Education.
No, it's a crime to waste youth on the young. Have you ever heard that? You
no.
have now. Richard, all the good rolls.
All right.
They're all
nine,
good.
Nine for the car. Nine for the car. Need a car. Need a car. Nine for the car.
Six.
I'll take the six.
Six in column three, all righty. Answer yes or no to this, Janine and Richard. Yes or no. Is Frank Sinatra married? Richard.
Yes.
Absolutely. Here's lovely Barbara. We live in Palm Springs, California. Richard, one bad roll. Six. One bad roll. You're going to roll it anyway. All right, stay away from the six.
Let's go for a nine. Nine for the car. Nine for the car. Nine.
A seven.
Seven.
Good
I'll
roll.
Take this. Three and four, please.
Three and the four. Having trouble making up his mind. If you mix saltpeter, sulfur, and charcoal, will you come up with gunpowder? Richard. Yes, gunpowder. You got it. He didn't even need the choice. Richard, the good roll, 7, 8, 9, and 10. What do you want to do?
I'm going to pass him.
Janine, to be such a nice person, you wouldn't know that to look at him. He's going to let you roll the dice. 7, 8, 9, and 10. That's what you need.
And it's going to be a 9. Come on, dice.
7, 8, 9, 10, or a double.
Give me a 9.
It's a 10. That's a good roll. One way to do it.
9 and 1.
9 and 1, clearing column three for the trip to London and that antique stove worth $6,449. Yours to keep, Janine, if you win the game, and you sure need this game. Legally, can you write your will on a Kleenex, yes or no? Richard?
Yes.
Absolutely. You can write it on anything, actually. Yes, you can. All right, Richard, again, decision time, 7 and 8. I think I know what you're going to do, but will you pass the dice?
Yes.
Janine, you got to roll a 7, an 8, or a double to stay alive, not only in this game, but in this match.
Oh, I know. Come
you
on,
need
guys.
This game, 7, 8, or double.
Hey.
Oh, you got a beautiful chance. It's a double. Yeah. And you need to roll again right now. We'll have to put you out of this match. You got a double, get a free roll. Again, you need a 7 or an 8, or a double to stay alive in the match.
7 or 8.
Does she do it? She got a 6. No. And Richard continues as our champion. Congratulations to you, Richard.
Thank you.
You didn't win any prizes, but you picked up another $100, taking your championship total to $17,970 cash and prizes. And Janine, although you didn't win cash or prizes on this, your second time around, we do have some nice parting gifts for you. And it was nice seeing you again. Thank you for playing High Roller.
Nice being here.
Thank you, Janine. Good luck to you.
Thanks.
Richard, what does that bell mean? Are we out of time? I believe we are. The spotlight will be on you first thing on the next show, Richard, as we play the big numbers with you for $10,000 in cash. That's what we'll do first thing on the next show. So we have Crystal and KC coming out here to join me as we say goodbye. We hope to see you next time. Please join us for High Rollers. Goodbye, everybody.
Some of our party contestants will receive Simple Green, the revolutionary water-activated cleaner and degreaser. Simple Green, the heavy-duty concentrate that is non-toxic, non-flammable, and biodegradable. And Cool Vapor Hank's Craft Humidifier adds moisture to dry room air for up to 20 hours. Hank's Craft Humidifier from Gerber Products Company. Plus Goldline, the second-best source of vitamins after Mother Nature. Goldline, the brand name in vitamins. And this microwave cooking guide that teaches you to cook automatically for your microwave. Furnished by Tappan, manufacturers of fine appliances.
Take a captivating look at the dangerous world of high finance investigation. Discover a private eye named Matt Houston, returning weeknights at 6, only on Coffee Stereo TV 20.
We're like an hour and a half away from the Perry Mason specials right here on Coffee Stereo TV 20. So stay tuned. Guess what's next? The $100,000 pyramid.
This has been a Merrill Heater production in association with Century Towers Productions.
Exotic car.
We got what you're looking for. TV 20.
Stereo.
KOFY, Coffee, TV 20, San Francisco.
$7,000 to $10,000.
She's done
it. And now a game of high stakes, where every decision is a gamble and every move could be your last. High Roller! And here's the man with all the action, Wink Martindale!
Yes! I got the gold wins today. Hello, Richard. Welcome back. Thank you very much, everybody. Welcome to High Roller. Skills, strategy, sabotage, and these unpredictable dice are the elements of our show. By the way, a brand new match will begin shortly, but first we have some unfinished business. A champion from our last match. Say hello once again, everybody, to Richard Harrison from Tucson, Arizona.
Thank you.
Richard, welcome. Richard, would like to say hi to, I think, your parents, who are High Rollers fans in Las Vegas.
Big fans.
In
they
Vegas?
They watch the show every single day, and my father showed me how to shoot crap.
Yeah?
Yeah. About a couple weeks ago, and...
Well, apparently he did his job well.
Yeah.
You've won $17,970 so far in cash and prizes. And when you win a match, as you did on the last show, you win the right to play our big numbers for $10,000. You're about to do that. You know it can be done because you saw it at the top of the show from a former champion knock them off. With these dice, all you have to do is put out the numbers. I'll give you $100 for each number you knock off, get them all nine, and you win $10,000. And to help you, of course, we always have these insurance markers. You throw a double, this can get you out of trouble. Audience, bring him on home to victory, will you?
I can do
here
it.
Here we go.
I can do it.
Big numbers. You got $300, Richard.
Keep it going.
We're going to see if your dad shows you right.
Eight. I'll take these 6 and 2, please.
6 and 2 is the way he elects to take them off.
Okay. Let's go. All right. Any good numbers?
$10,000 at stake if you can do it. Seven.
I'll take the 3 and 4.
3 and 4 come off. So, Richard, a 5 and 1. 6.
Gosh, okay.
3 and 3, 5 and 1.
Come on, for $10,000.
He makes the 9, and you can't do that. No good. You needed a 6 and didn't come up with it. You picked up 7 numbers for $100 apiece. That gives you $700 added to your prior winnings. $18,670. And you're still our champion, too. We'll need a new challenger for you, Richard. We'll come back right after this commercial break.
Bites you can take.
Now back to High Rollers and Away.
Okay, thank you, Dean. Well, Richard, ready to take on a new challenger, and that challenger is Carrie Berkner, originally from Calabasas, California.
Hi.
Hello, Carrie.
Nice to meet you.
And here's your latest call, Carrie, K-A-R-I.
My mom spelled it the hard way.
Listen, it says here that if you won $10,000 on our show, you'd be honeymooning in Jamaica. That's how you'd spend the money. That tells me you're about to get married?
Yes, I'm getting married in March to a wonderful man. His name is Lee. He couldn't be here today, but I'll see him soon.
Well, good luck to you, Carrie, and congratulations on your impending marriage. All right, we need prizes, and let's look at our three columns. Of course, let's start at the beginning. Dean Goss, column one, please.
It's Galaxy Designers Gallery. Custom design your own elegant handcrafted area rug. That's exactly right for you. Furnished by Galaxy Carpet Mills. And this area rug will give you years of enjoyment, as will this back-saver chair with vertical and horizontal adjustments, plus the stressless horizontal position determined by NASA for our astronauts on takeoff. In teak wood and leather, furnished by Backsaver Products, it makes the value of the column $1,899.
Now let's go to the center column and see what we find there, Dean.
Something that appreciates in value. It's two for tea. Part of Norman Rockwell's Four Ages of Love series. A lithograph numbered and signed by the artist. Furnished by Steve Stein Gallery and is valued at $3,000.
Now let's move over next door and finish up with column three.
In the classic French style, it's this pair of white candelabras and eagle crown mantel clock, hand-painted and imported from Italy by Barons Wilshire. And you can place them on this Italian sofa table, which features masterful hand carving and beveled marble top. Sure to add elegance to almost any room, from Charles & Charles. This column is valued at $2,050, and the game has a value of $6,949.
All right, that's just for this game alone. Let's see the numbers. Hot column for the game between Carrie and Richard. Column one, meaning a roll of a 12, will give you the gorgeous rug and chair worth almost $2,000. Carrie, Richard, first question. Is late night host Johnny Carson 16 or 26 years old? How about it, Richard?
26.
Yeah, 26 years older than his wife, Alex. That was going to be... You took a guess at that. I think you took a calculated risk and won. All right, roll the dice.
Coming out, let's go for the 12. Box card, box card.
First roll, nine.
Let me take the... 4, 3, and a 2.
You got it. 4, 3, and 2. Come off. Jupiter, Cupid, or Hercules? Who is the Roman god of love? Carrie.
Cupid.
Yes. Cupid, the Roman god of love. Here comes the first roll, lovely. Pick them up. Yeah, bad rolls. You got 2, 3, and 4.
I'm sorry, Richard, but you're going to have to roll.
The two bad rolls, Richard, are 3 and 4. She wants you to roll them. She has a feeling you're going to come up with a 3 or a 4. Let's find out.
Let's go for it.
That'd give her
eight.
A quick game,
eight.
Wouldn't it?
Eight.
Stay away from a 3 or a 4.
Nine. I'll take the 9, Richard.
All right, 9 in column 1, leaving only the 1 there.
The 8 to 1.
Now, you can't change it. Once it comes off the big columns up there, is your breastbone also called your sternum or your clavicle? Carrie.
Sternum.
Yes. Woo! You get the dice again. Pick them up. Here we go.
Okay.
Bad rolls are 3, 4, and 10.
Richard,
the bad rolls are 3, 4, and 10. Stay away from
now
those.
Now I'll go for the 9.
Win the game.
I'm going to do both columns.
Yeah, now 9.
Now I'll do the 9. 9.
All right, what
nine,
did you do?
Nine,
comes up good.
An 8. I'll take the 8.
All right, that clears column 2, giving you the lithograph that you wanted for $3,000. Yours to keep if you win the game. In the film Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, who played Butch? Robert Redford or Paul Newman? How about it, Richard?
Robert Redford.
No, Paul Newman played Butch. And again, Carrie, you gained control of the dice. This is not working out for you so far. However, the bad rolls, there are 4 of them, 3, 4, 9, and 10. What do you want to do?
Well, Richard, these are for you.
She is such a nice lady. She's going to present you with 2 very pretty black and white dice. Stay away from the 3, the 4, the 9, and the 10.
Just good numbers. Come on,
the bad rolls.
Just good numbers. Good numbers. Good numbers.
He has rolled a 5.
5.
That's a good roll for you, Richard.
I'll take the 5.
Off comes the 5, leaving the 6 and the 7 in column 3. Here's your next question. The mass of men lead lives of quiet desperation. Were these words written by Shakespeare? Richard.
Shakespeare.
No, Thoreau. Thoreau. All right, Gary, the good rolls, 6, 7, and 8. What's your pleasure? She's so torn, but she's going to get through it. Good roll. 6, 7, and 8. Richard, see if you can do it.
Any good roll.
6, 7, 8, or
nothing.
Does he do it? Yeah, he did.
An 8. Oh, I'll take a 7 and a 1.
7 and a 1 come off. That clears column 1 for the rug and the chair worth $1,899. Yes or no? Just yes or no. Does lightning ever... Richard.
Yes.
Yes, it does. Does lightning ever strike the same place twice?
It did already.
It really does, right. All right, Richard, you control the dice. There's only one left up there that's still alive, and that's the six. Gary, you need to win the game. You need to roll a six or a double.
Yes,
she did. She rolled a five. Game goes to Richard. Oh, you're so proud of yourself, aren't you? Gary, you gave him the dice so many times. Actually, you answered more questions, but he had more rolls, and he came up with winning rolls. Okay, that gives you a total now, including the litho, the rug, and the chair, of $23,569, Richard. That gives you the first game of the match. Gary, you even it up with a win in game two. Here we go to game two, and in column one, Dean, for this match, what do we have?
An exquisite oriental queen-size bedroom suite, hand-painted on white lacquer finish with gleaming brass trim. The suite includes headboard, armoire, and two nightstands furnished by Paul Tsai Furniture Manufacturing Company and valued at $2,676.
All right, let's move on to the center column. How did you like this?
This antique French walnut desk with hand-carved cherubs and garland is as useful today as it was in days gone by. And look, it features a touch-push secret compartments. Furnished by Charles and Charles and valued at $6,000.
Boy, that's a gorgeous thing. Hey, how about playing a game within our game? Listen.
It's an extra special attraction that we call Love Letters. And you're going to love it because simply by rolling to die, you could be rolling home in a brand new car. Like this Mazda 626 sedan. It comes standard with a 2.2-liter overhead cam engine, patented independent rear suspension, plus many luxury features furnished by Mazda. This column has a potential value of $13,280, which gives the board a potential value of $21,956.
$21,000 game, and that's only this game. Do we have prizes or not? Here are the way the numbers line up. And the hot column for this game is column three, meaning a roll of a 10 will give you the chance to play Love Letters and a new car valued at over $13,000. We're going to take a quick break, and then we'll be right back. Don't go away.
This.
Now back to Wings and more High Rollers.
All right, Gary, you need this game to even things up at a game apiece. When Cher had cosmetic surgery in the 1970s, did she end up with a tighter tummy, a bouncier bosom, or a firmer fanny? How about that, Carrie?
A firmer fanny.
No, a bouncier bosom, as a matter of fact. Wow. Yeah, that's why she went in. Richard, you get to roll them. Roll of the dice in this game.
The car. I need a car.
Win this game, you'll take the match. You'd love to play that game called Love Letters.
I'll take the 4 and the 1.
All right, 4 and the 1 come off, leaving only the 5 in column 3. If someone says you're non compos mentis, does it mean that you're sexy or crazy? Richard.
Crazy.
You are crazy. Yes.
Yes.
You are right. All right, Richard, pick him up. One bad roll, 4. What do you want to do? Roll it, Richard, or
I'm
give
gonna
you
roll. I'm going to roll.
All right. Knock off that 5. You get to play
Let's
Love
go.
Letters if you win the
five,
game.
5. 5.
You
5 for the car. 5 for the car. 5 for the car.
Twice, huh? 7.
7. I'll take a 5-2.
5 and the 2 come off. We credit you with column 3, the Love Letters game. $13,280, the value of column 3 if you win the game. A beautiful painting called Irises sold for a record 53. Richard.
Van Gogh.
Yes. Van Gogh is the correct answer. Let me finish that. Sold for a record $53.9 million in 1987. Who painted it? Picasso or Van Gogh? By the way, during his lifetime, interesting statement, Van Gogh only sold one painting, and that one was for $30. Just thought I'd put that in. All right. I am full of information like that. Richard, what do you want to do? 2 bad rolls, 4 and 5. Gary?
So nice of you.
Stay away from the 4 or 5.
Okay. Well, I need some bedroom furniture. I'm getting married. So come on, give me an 8 or 6. 8 or 6.
Just stay away from the 4 or 5. 9.
9.
That's a good roll.
I'll take the 6 and the 3.
6 and the 3 come off. All righty. According to best-selling science author Desmond Morris, at what age are most males at their highest sexual peak? Karen.
19.
No, 18. 18, 20. I would love to ask her why she said 19, but I'm not going to do it. All right, Richard, what are you going to do? You want to roll them, give them to Carrie.
Carrie, they're all yours.
Carrie, the good rolls are 7, 8, and 9.
Get me
7, 8, and 9. Does she come up with a 7, 8, or 9? She got a double. 6. Bad roll, but it's a double. So you get another roll. Get another opportunity to come up with 7, 8, or 9.
All right, I'll take any of them.
If he wins the game, he's going to get to play Love Letters. What'd she come up with? 11. And the game and the match go to Richard. He gets to play Love Letters. Well, congratulations once again, Richard.
Thank you.
You not only get to go up against the big numbers shortly for $10,000, but you're also going to get to play the love letters game for a possible new car and over $13,000 its value. Hang on for just a second. Carrie, doggone, you didn't pick up any cash or prizes or that bedroom set you wanted for your marriage that's coming up. But we wish you all the happiness in the world in that upcoming marriage.
Thank you so much for being with us
on High Road.
Good luck,
Richard. Gary, with his fiance up in San Francisco. He's going to be proud of her anyway. All right, Richard, we have a game called Love Letters. You still have a game to play. And let's start the action. Take a look and listen. Richard, we call this Love Letters because the letters you're looking for just may give you a prize you will dearly love. The brand new Mazda 626. There are six spaces up there. Six spaces numbered 1 through 6, concealing a common everyday word. You'll get 6 rolls with one of those die. Every time you roll a new number, you'll get a letter. Following your 6th roll of the die, you'll have 5 seconds to tell me the word. Now, you may take only one guess. If you guess the word, the car is yours. It's that simple. Now, if you don't guess the word, I'll still give you $100 for each letter that you receive. All righty? So take that die in front of you. And for the car, go for it. All righty?
All right, let's get the one first. One first. One.
You got 6 rolls. First roll comes up.
One.
All right. First letter in the word is a W. And you have 5 letters left.
All right.
5 rolls
down
for line. 5
down
letters.
Down the line. 2 now.
All right. He comes up with a 2. That's a good way to kick it off. A W and an E. First 2 letters of the word you're looking for.
Let's
you have
go.
4 rolls left.
How about a 3?
Trying to go for a new Mazda. Boy, wouldn't that be nice? He wants a 3. He gets a 5. And that letter is...
All right.
A T. Now you have 3 letters up there. You have 3 rolls left. It's possible to fill in the entire word.
How about a 6? 6.
He wants
six.
A 6. Does
Go
he get
six.
It? Comes up with another 3. And that letter is an A. W-E-A and T. 4 and 6. 2 letters left.
Okay.
You can do it.
How about a 6? 6.
2 rolls left.
Six.
And he comes up with a 4. And that letter is an L. You might as well try. I think he knows it. However, you got 1 roll left. Let's see if you can do it. Can he roll a 1 and come up with that
6,
with that
six,
word, that
six,
common everyday
six,
word? A
3.
All right. There it is. For the Mazda 626, what do you think the word is? You'll have 5 seconds, and then I'll need your answer.
Wealth.
Is it wealth? Let's see if we fill in an H. You got it.
Yeah.
A brand new car.
Yeah.
A Mazda 626 is yours.
I need a car. Oh, I need that car.
Did you need a car?
Oh, gosh. Mine is the plunger of the
well,
world.
You made it look easy the way you put them all in there. The Mazda 626 is yours. That takes his total winnings as our champion, including the car, up to $36,849.
Thank you.
Richard, we're going to turn the spotlight on you now as you face the big numbers for a chance at $10,000. Here's Casey Winkler with a golden dice. And you possibly, if you knock them all off, can end up after this with $46,849. We're going to take a commercial break. Don't get too uptight. We'll find out if he can do it. Beat the big numbers for another $10,000 right after this commercial break.
Now, Rams Palace Furniture in Richmond.
Now back to Wayne for those big numbers.
And I applaud you, Richard, because you're a good champ. This is the fourth time at trying to beat the big numbers. Maybe 4 will be a charm this time for you.
I hope so.
With these dice, all you have to do is put out the big numbers. You know how it works. $100 for each number. Get them all 9 of them. $10,000 we give you. That would take you over $46,000 in winning as our champion. We always have these insurance markers. If you throw a double, this can get you out of trouble and give you an extra roll. Audience, do you think he can do this?
Yeah!
Should we let him try?
Yes!
He's earned the opportunity.
Yes.
Now do it, Richard.
I can do
We're
it.
Pulling
big
for
numbers,
you.
Big numbers,
for $10,000.
Big numbers,
he rolls a 4 and a 2.
I'll take the 6.
All right, off comes the 6.
Okay, big numbers.
And maybe
numbers.
This is the start
numbers,
of something big.
Big numbers, big numbers, big numbers.
Big numbers,
big numbers.
8.
I'll take the 8, please.
All right, off comes the 8. First the 6, then the 8. You have $200. Reaching for a big 10. $10,000.
Let's go.
He has rolled a 2 and a 6. 8 again.
I'll take the 7 and the 1. Then.
7 and the 1 come off. All right. 2, 3, 4, 5.
All right, let's
nine,
go.
And
let's
all
go.
The combinations in between is still
numbers,
good.
Good number.
8.
I'll take the 5 and the 3. Then.
5 and 3. Do one of those, leaving the 2, the 4, and the 9. All righty, you're up to $600. Reaching
let's
for
10,000. Let's go for the 9. Let's go for the 9. Let's go for the 9.
10. No good. You can't do that. No, that was one of the bad rolls. Sorry, Richard. However, you picked up $600, 6 numbers. added to your prior winnings, taking you now to $37,449 in cash and prizes. You're still the champ, about to meet a brand new challenger, and here comes that lady right now. Her name is Carolyn Cole, originally from Agoura, California. Thank you, Crystal. Hello there, Carolyn. Welcome to High Rollers. And what do you do?
I'm a trial attorney in the San Fernando Valley, and I've just gone into practice with my father.
Well, terrific. Good luck in that career, and good luck here on High Rollers, Carolyn, a lady trial attorney. All right, we want to show you some new prizes. We've got three column worth of great prizes up here, and in column one, Carolyn and Richard, here's what we have. Dean?
Emerson's 10-inch color television with electronic tuning is available in red or white and is fully designed to be a fashion accessory in almost any setting. A fine product furnished by Emerson. And it complements part of Lloyd Flanders' heirloom series Love Seat Lounge Chair and End Table. Man-made all-weather wicker furniture pieces are designed for use indoors or out. Furnished by Lloyd Flanders. And it makes the value of the column $1,395.
Let's move over to the center column, Dean, if you will, please.
From Barefoot Miss of California, swimsuits in vibrant colors that take to sunny skies at sea and on shore. Barefoot Miss sends temperatures soaring, and you'll take them with you when we fly you to Honolulu aboard a giant jet, where you may enjoy the comfort and in-flight services of Continental Airlines. Once there, you'll cruise the Hawaiian Islands aboard the SS Independence or Constitution. Depart from Honolulu, visit five ports and four islands. An unforgettable seven-day vacation furnished by American Hawaii Cruises. This column has a value of $5,250.
And moving over to column three.
It's Magnavox Video Escorts, a compact, fully automatic camcorder with high-speed shutter to capture fast action and play it back instantly. Furnished by Magnavox. Then start the action when we fly you to New Zealand on Air New Zealand's wide-bodied 747. On the way, you may enjoy personalized Pacific cuisine service, everything from hot entrees to a warm Kiwi smile. Furnished by Air New Zealand. Once there, you'll spend a week at the Regent of Auckland, a luxury international hotel featuring fine dining and elegant amenities. Located conveniently in downtown Auckland, New Zealand. Furnished by the Region of Auckland. This column has a value of $5,280. And the board is valued at $11,925.
All those prizes and only for this game. Here come the numbers. Hot column for this game, column one, meaning a roll of an eight, will give you the furniture and the television worth $1,395. However, the doorbell means we got to scoot out the door and make room for somebody else. So Carolyn and Richard will get you started on this match first thing on tomorrow's show. In the meantime, Wink Martindale for High Rollers. Goodbye, everybody.
Some of our party contestants will receive Simple Green, the revolutionary water-activated cleaner degreaser. Simple Green, the heavy-duty concentrate that is non-toxic, non-flammable, and biodegradable. And Uncle Ben's Boiling Bag Rice. It's in the bag. No measuring, no mess. Family and single-size servings in 10 minutes. Plus Gold Line, the second best source of vitamins after Mother Nature. Gold Line, the new brand name in vitamins. And this microwave cooking guide that teaches you to cook automatically for your microwave. Furnished by Tappan, manufacturers of fine appliances.
Boy, do we listen to you. Hogan's Heroes is back starting Monday at 5:30 on Coffee Stereo TV 20, preceded by the Beverly Hillbillies. Join us Monday at 5. Let's keep the game show action going on Coffee Stereo TV 20. How about Dick Clark, the $100,000 pyramid coming up next? Then it's Matt Houston from Coffee. We just keep getting better.
This has been a Merrill Heater production in association with Century Towers Productions.
These three contestants are about to play the most exciting game of their lives. Returning champion Miriam Voorhees has already won $16,708. Tom Bailey hopes to better that figure today, but Draya Maddox has other plans for both of them. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. Here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter DeMarcus.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Hi, thank you, Rod Roddy, and welcome to Press Your Luck, the most competitive game in television. And today, we're happy to salute our friends who watch WBNS in Columbus, Ohio. WBNS joined our station lineup earlier this month, and we're pleased to have them with us. Welcome. Now let's meet the players who are going to be pressing their luck today, starting with Tom.
How you doing, Pete?
Tom, how are you?
I'm real fine. And yourself?
I'm just great. Tom, nobody asked me that. I'm really glad you asked me. Well, I should probably have you interview me.
But, no, thank you. You can have me.
Let me interview. Tom, you have an unusual hobby?
Well, probably my favorite hobby is ice fishing. It's something I don't get to do much of out here in California, but I grew up in Maine, and we had to do something through those long, cold, snowy winters, and I took to ice fishing.
You sit out, actually, with a little hole in the thing. And
little hole, freezing, little fire.
You look smart, Tom.
I hope so.
Let's see what happens. Okay. Welcome, Tom. And let's meet Draya, who also, I was told, has an unusual hobby. Everybody's got unusual hobbies. What is yours, Draya?
My hobby is gaining and losing weight.
Should I ask you which phase you're in? Losing.
Tight. Losing starts next.
All right, if you win some money, you'll change it back, right? All right, Draya, best of luck. And our returning champion, Miriam,
Hello.
With over $16,000.
Isn't that wonderful?
It's pretty good. Good for you. It's not great for me. It's not my $16,000, but it's still great for you.
That
what are you going to do with it?
What am I going to do? It's going to go in my dowry.
Oh, boy. Are the switchboards lighting up? I'm sure they will be. All right, everybody. Are you all ready?
Absolutely.
Yes, I've got four questions, and your correct answers will earn you spins at the Big Press Your Luck game board. And as you know, the more spins you have, the more money you can win. Because our board is loaded with thousands of dollars in cash and terrific prizes, and every time you stop at the board like this, stop, you'll win money, like I did. However, you can also hit a whammy. If you do that, the rascal jumps out and takes away all your money, reduces you to zero, and you don't want to do that, do you?
No.
All right, let's get some spins, which turns into dollars. Here's the first question. People Magazine tells us that one of the stars of Dallas has a bulletproof bathroom. Which one is it? Well, you can't. So it's the upstairs bathroom? No, you can't do that. All right. I'm going to give it to you, class, as a multiple choice. If you get it right, I'll give you a spin. All right. The Dallas star with the bulletproof bathroom is Larry Hagman, Victoria Principal, or Linda Gray? Tom, what do you think?
Larry Hagman.
Larry Hagman, says Tom. Let's find out what Draya has to say.
The man you love to hate, Larry Hagman.
The man you love to hate. All right, Draya. Miriam, what do you think?
I don't think he wants to get shot again. Larry Hagman.
Larry Hagman. Well, that bulletproof bathroom belongs to Victoria Principal. I don't even want to know why she has it, but whatever. Different strokes for different folks. No spins. Second question is, pretend we just started again, okay? The America's Cup was recently won by an Australian yacht simply named Australia 2. But what was the name of the American yacht? Draya?
Liberty.
Liberty, all right. Draya, if you're right, you're going to pick up three spins. You know what I'm going to do. I'm going to give your answer and two others to Tom and Miriam. If they're right, they'll get a spin apiece. All right, is the correct answer Liberty, Freedom, or Challenger, Tom?
I'll say Liberty.
Tom will say Liberty. We'll go over to Miriam to see what she says.
I'll agree, Liberty.
Liberty. Well, our losing vote was Liberty.
Yay!
Everybody picks up spins. Tom goes to one, Draya to three, and Miriam to one. It was a 132-year winning history that was ended. Sad. Well, third question. Name the style of hat made popular by Jackie Kennedy. Draya.
A pillbox.
Pillbox, all right, is the correct answer. Pillbox. Tam O'Shanter or cloche, Tom?
I'll have to agree with her, pillbox.
Well, you don't have to, but you're going to, I guess, right? Pillbox? All right, let's jump over to Miriam and see what she says.
Sounds good to me. Pillbox?
Pillbox. Well, Jackie Kennedy made the pillbox popular. Well done. Everybody picked a spin. Tom goes to two. Draya goes to six. And Miriam goes to two. We got to move those spins. When are they going to happen? Tom goes to two. There he goes. Draya goes to six. I guess I have to say it twice. Miriam goes to two. We didn't forget you, Miriam. You're all set. Here we go with the fourth and final question. In the sports world, what have you received when someone gives you a pair of ducats? Tom.
Tickets.
Tickets, all right. Is the correct answer tickets, binoculars, or dice? Draya?
Tickets,
you say?
Tickets.
All right, let's see what Miriam has to say.
Tickets?
Tickets. Ducats are another name for tickets.
All right.
Correct, everybody again. Tom goes to five, Draya to seven, and Miriam goes to three. And you're all going to have a chance to convert your spins into dollars at the Big Press Your Luck game board when we come back. Players, as you can see, there are prizes, and there are a lot of surprises. There's over $13,000 in cash, and of course, a few whammies up there on that game board. Now, each time you spend, you can bring up to $1,500 to your total, and that is important, because the player who ends this round on top plays last in the final round, and that is a big advantage. Remember, you can pass your remaining spends anytime you have an overpowering fear of the whammy, and everything is at stake each time you spend. Four whammies makes you history. Be out of the game, okay? The player with the fewest spins is Miriam, our champion. You get to go first, Miriam. Are you ready?
No, I'm going to pass. No, no.
Oh, cute, Miriam, real cute. Here we go.
Okay. Stop.
Stop at $350. Right. Into the money column. Two spins left. I won't even ask you, Miriam.
You know by now.
Miriam's a go-getter. Stop at $500. Right. $850, real quick. One spin left. What do you think?
I'm cooking.
She's
time
cooking.
To go.
Miriam's cooking.
Okay, Dad, for you. Stop.
Stop at a home computer for Dad, worth $765, Miriam. That brings your total up to $1,615. Well done. We're now going to go over and sit chat with Tom, who has no dollars, five spins, and has been kind of sitting on the ice waiting to fish. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Here we
Let's go,
Tom. Catch a big one.
Stop.
Stop at $200.
All right.
If you don't want to catch a whammy, 204 spins.
I'm going to press
on.
My luck.
Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at $500. Right. $700. Total three spins left. Second place. We've yet to hear from a whammy. Maybe he's in Maine fishing. Here we go.
Stop.
A pool table.
Right.
Value of $895. Nice pool table. That brings you to $1,595. About $20 less than Miriam. Two spins left. Press your luck or pass.
I'm going to press on.
He's going to go on. Here we go.
Stop.
$400. $1,995. Good number. One spin left. You are now in first place by over $350. What are you going to do?
Go on.
Whoa, Tom's going on. Risking that first place, $1,995.
Stop.
Stop at $500. Tom's got this game down. $2,495. First place. Now let's talk to Draya, who's been patiently awaiting her seven spins, no dollars. Draya, ready to go for it?
I'm ready to go.
Okay.
Stop.
Stop and advance two spaces to $750. Six spins left. Third place. Gonna go on.
Gonna
get in second place.
Stop.
Think about $500. $1,250, still second place, about $400 less than Mary.
I have to go.
I have to go.
Stop.
Stop at $550. Now it's a little different, Draya. $1,800 to Miriam, $1,615. About $185 more than Miriam, second place, four spins. Has to go one more.
Stop.
Stop at, move one space to either $750 or $100 and a stick.
I'll go for the $750.
You're going for the money. Yeah, I would too, Draya. That brings your total up to $2,550. Three spins left. You have about $50 more. I didn't even have to tell you, did I? Draya is making the magic motion that the spins now go to Tom, since he's the player with the next highest amount of money. There they are, Tom. Three pass spins you've got to take. We'll take them one at a time, though, and make them easier. Tom, you don't want a whammy.
Stop.
Stop at a swivel rocker. That certainly is no whammy. Value of $758, Tom. $3,253. Well into first place. Let's see if you can stay there.
Stop.
Stop.
Finally.
He thought he had the right stuff. He had the stuff to obliterate your monies, Tom. Now we're going to do you a little bit of a favor. We're going to take the two spins that are in the pass column, move them over to the earn column, which means, or the one, rather, which means you can take that one spin or you can pass it to Draya. Your option. You're in third place with no dollars.
I might as well go on.
Yeah. Here we go.
Stop.
Oh, again. Two in a row. Sorry, I laughed. I had never seen that one, and I would imagine you've been happier never seeing it either. All right, Tom, you've got $0. We've got Miriam at $1,615, and Draya, you're in the lead with $2,550, which you know is a big advantage. We'll be right back with more questions, spins, prizes, and surprises right after this. All right, players, you know what I've got. I've got a cold. No, it has nothing to do. I have four more questions.
which means four more golden opportunities to earn some spins of the big board. And as you know, the more spins you get, the more money you can win. That's what it's all about. Remember, the player who wins this round gets to keep all the money they won and come back again tomorrow. Nice guys, huh? We're very generous. All right, here's your first question. According to a Gallup survey, what do more women list as their most hated household chore? Tom?
Laundry.
Laundry, Tom says. And Dre's laughing at you, Tom, because you buzzed in. Laundry, says Tom. All right, is the correct answer. Laundry. Cleaning the bathroom. Washing dishes, Drea.
Washing dishes.
Washing dishes. Drea didn't hesitate a bit. Miriam, what do you think?
I hate the bathroom, but everybody else hates washing dishes.
Hates washing dishes. Well, the chore ladies hate most is washing dishes. Tom, you weren't expected to know the answer. No problem. Drea and Miriam each get a spin apiece. Where's your spin, Miriam? Don't worry about it, Tom. Do you do the dishes?
Yes.
Oh, well, that's why she doesn't hate it, because you do
like
them. All right, here's the second question. If you're like most of your fellow Americans, what kind of soup do you order in restaurants? Drea.
Vegetable.
Vegetable. All right, is the correct answer. Vegetable, tomato, or onion, Tom?
Onion.
Onion, says Tom. Let's go over to Miriam and see what she says.
Vegetable.
Vegetable. Well, most of us order vegetable soup.
Correct.
All right, Tom stays at zip. Drea goes to four. Miriam, two. Here's your third question. 7 years ago, the company that makes M&Ms removed this color from the rainbow of colors the popular candy comes in. What color has been missing since 1976, Miriam?
Red.
All right, is the correct answer red, blue, or yellow, Tom?
Blue.
Blue, says Tom. After some consideration, Drea, what do you think?
I'd go with blue.
You'd go with blue. Well, since 1976, M&Ms have had no red candy.
All right.
Miriam's right. Tom, no spins. Drea, four, and Miriam goes to five. Here's the fourth and final question. Tom, gotta get some spins. A recent New England Journal of Medicine article stated that scenes showing actors drinking alcoholic beverages have almost doubled on TV's dramatic shows. But what vice has almost disappeared from these same programs? Tom.
Smoking cigarettes.
Smoking. All right. Is the correct answer smoking, sex, or drugs, Drea?
Smoking.
Smoking, says Drea. We'll go over to Miriam and see what she says.
Has to be cigarettes.
Cigarette smoking on TV. There's less and less smoking.
All right.
All right. Tom, you pull it out. Three spins. Drea goes to five. And Miriam goes to six. All right. All our players will be taking those spins to the big board. Decide who the winner will be on Fresh Luck. We come back right after this.
As the world turns and the young and the restless weekdays.
All right, players. Without much ado, we're going to get to find out who the winner's going to be on this game. Remember, there's $50,000 up there waiting to be won. You want to watch out for the whammy because he can nail you if he comes to you. Four of them put you out of the game. We have Tom with no dollars, Miriam with $16.15, and Drea with $25.50. That means you're going to play last, Drea, since you came in first in the last round. And that puts you in the driver's seat. Sit back and relax. Let's go to Tom, who has the least dollars, three spins, two whammies. Tom, I think you're cutting the ice out where you're going to fish, but you're standing on top of it. Here we go.
It's time to catch a big one. Let's go. Big box. Stop!
$750, all right, Tom! All right. $752 spins left. What are you going to do?
We're going to press
place.
On.
We're going to press on. I want to get into second place before we start thinking about
stop.
The pass. $1,200! All right. That'll do it, Tom. That'll put you up to $1,950. Second place, $300 more than Miriam. What are you going to do?
I'm going to press on.
Press on one more. All you need is
stop.
Stop at $2,500! Well done, Tom! $44.50, well into first place. Let's go over to Miriam, who has $16.15, six spins. Are you ready to press your luck, champ?
I'm ready.
Here we go.
Stop
at $500. $21.15, five spins. Miriam, I know you're going, right?
You know it.
I do. Stop at $1,000. You now have $31.15, second place. Four spins, press your luck or pass.
Yes, I'm going to press on.
Here we go. Stop at $2,000. You're now in first place with one spin. $5,115. Three spins left. What are you going to do? First place by about $700. You're impressed. Miriam's going to press. We haven't had a whammy this round yet.
Stop
at $2,500. That brings you up to $7,615. Two spins left. Press your luck or pass. would have fainted by now. What are
Ellen
you
going to
do?
Ellen
asked it. Maybe you have to pass
I want
to.
Pass.
All right, they go to Tom. Do you think the player with the next highest amount of money?
They do?
Tom, they do
I
go
didn't
to Tom.
Know.
You didn't know. You didn't know.
I did know, but I wasn't.
Would you want to pass them to Tom?
I want to take one more spin.
You want to take another spin?
I'm kind
well,
of your
I'll
problem.
I have to go to the judges and see what we're going to do.
I passed them.
Pass them?
I'm sorry.
If they pass, they're passed. They're all over there to
okay.
Tom.
I'm
Tom,
sorry.
You've got two spins you've got to take. 44.50 at stake. Two whammies. Are you ready?
I am ready. Stop.
Stop at four. $500 and a spin. All right, Tom. That gives you $8,450. One more spin you want to take. You want to avert that whammy's gaze. Lest you lose your winning ways.
Come on.
Here we go.
No.
Let's see if Miriam dies. $500. The hex didn't work, Tom. You've got $8,950. One spin left that you can go with, or you can pass it back to Miriam. It would... Tom's going for it. He wants the big bucks.
Stop.
$500. All right, Tom. You defy the odds. $9,450 first place. Miriam's at $76.15. Here comes Draya with $25.50. Here we go, Draya.
Yay.
Third place.
Stop.
Stop at $750. $3,300 even. Four spins left. Third place. Gonna go?
Yeah.
That's what I thought. Looking for
Stop.
$1,400. $4,700. Still third place. Three spins.
Okay.
Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at Sebring, Florida. A trip worth $2,176. Draya, that gives you $6,876. Two spins left. You are still in third place by about $800. What's she gonna do, Draya?
One more.
One more, she says. Wants to get up into second place. $750. Let's see what that does to your total. That gives you $76.26, which is $11 more than Miriam. One spin left. Oh, it's going. Here it comes, Tom. One spin left. If you can avert the whammy, you'll be the champion. If not, it's going to be Draya. Are you ready, Draya? Tom, are you ready?
I'm
Here's
ready.
The thing you've got to take. Here we go. Who's the new champ going to be? Draya or Tom?
Stop.
Stop. And it's done. It's done. And Tom did it. Congratulations. $15.99 is that dining set. And that means you're the biggest winner on Trust Your Luck today with $10,849. Tom, hang in there because we're going to come back and tell you exactly what you won right after this message. Today's Trust Your Luck winner, Tom. And guess what, Tom? The illustrious Rod Roddy is going to tell you exactly what you want, aren't you, Rod?
I sure will, Peter. Tom, you won an elegant new dining room set. Virginia Colony by Bassett features a charming oval table and four chairs, a lighted hutch with two glass shelves and china vase and a server, all in a pilgrim maple finish worth $1,399. Combined with the $9,450 in cash that you won, gives you a grand total, Tom, of $10,849. Congratulations!
Congratulations, Tom! Miriam, you didn't make it today, but you're going to go home with $16,708, and you've been terrific. You're a real lively contestant. I thank you for being with us. All right, good collaboration, society. Dre, you played it brilliantly. Luck got in the way. We've got some nice prizes for you for playing with us. I want to thank you, and we're going to see you again tomorrow, Tom. And remember, reach out for too much, and the whammy will get you into serious Dutch. This is Peter DeMarkin saying so long for Press Your Luck. Bye-bye. Beautiful.
we have for our departing contestants. Official double action floor sweepers, tapped up dirt and litter off carpets and bare floors. Great for quick pickups between vacuuming from Bissell. Plus, Kentucky Fried Chicken gift certificates and special thermal bags. Don't forget the fresh made from scratch buttermilk biscuits, too. All from Kentucky Fried Chicken. And sidewalk motocross fun by Headstrom. Knobby tires, mag wheels on a 16-inch bike from Headstrom. We put fun on wheels. Also, Success Boiling Bag Rice. Perfect every time. Once you taste the Success, nothing else will do. Plus, 4 gallons of super scrubbable, two-pass, easy care, latex, flat wall and trim finish for walls and woodwork. Only at True Value Hardware Stores. And maximum strength, Cortisone 5. Get under your hitch for fast relief or your money back. Guaranteed. See package for details. Use as directed.
Tonight, it's a star-studded cast in a hilarious send-up of Hollywood. Blake Edwards, SOB, Standard Operational Bull, tonight at 8:30, 7:30 Central and Mountain.
This is Rob Roddy speaking for Fred Your Luck at Carruthers Company presentation.
First item up for bid today on The Price is Right.
Drew, it's a new rowing machine. The Water Rower Natural is a solid ash hardwood finished indoor rowing machine with a honey oak stain, suitable for all levels of fitness, providing a full body workout for the entire family from waterrower.com.
Wow, Gwen's earning her money today. Michael, yeah. What's... Oh, the prize will go to the one who bids closest to the action retail price without going over. Michael.
$400.
Natalia.
Let's do $545.
Travis.
$699.
Sorry, what was the first bid?
$400, $545, and $699.
$700,
the actual retail price. $1,095. Christina.
How are you?
Oh my God.
How are you? How are you doing?
I can't.
You okay?
I can't breathe.
Take a minute to breathe. You can't breathe. That's going to be great. You know why?
Oh my God.
Tell me why, Rich.
Got a chance to win a cool beverage center and a pair of bicycles. First, you'll never be without your favorite beverage with this 112-can built-in silhouette beverage center. It features frosted glass shelving with blue LED lighting and is a classy addition to any home from Canby. And second, from Worksman Cycles comes a pair of sporty bicycles featuring dual automotive-style drum brakes, chrome-plated frames, and awesome strength. Aggressive for the adventurous rider from Worksman Cycle.
Little beverage cooler and his and hers bicycles. She's shaking like a leaf up
I'm
here.
I'm sorry.
Are you okay? You're
yeah,
be all right? I know it's exciting being next to Drew Carey.
Okay.
Who would be excited?
Bicycles and what?
Bicycles and a little cooler thing there.
Okay.
Yeah. Not including the beverages inside the cooler.
Okay.
I don't think they include the beverages. We're going to play the clock game. Did you ever see this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Here's how the clock game works. I know you're excited. I'm going to explain it to you. You have 30 seconds to bid on both prizes.
Okay.
You're going to bid on the cooler first and then the bicycle second. And what you're going to do is you're going to give me a bid, and I'm going to tell you whether the actual price is higher or lower than your bid.
Okay.
And you're going to keep bidding up and down until you get to the right bid. And when you're on the money, use the rest of the time to get to the next one. You ready?
Just a couple seconds.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
That's okay. Are you ready?
Okay, we're doing the cooler first.
Yeah, you're going to do the cooler first.
I'm ready.
Okay, I'm going to show the price to the audience. Don't help her out. Here's the price. Start bidding now.
$500.
What?
500.
Higher.
1,000.
Lower.
750.
Higher.
800.
Lower.
751.
Higher.
775.
Higher.
780.
Higher.
785.
Higher.
790.
Higher.
791, 792, 793, 794, 795, 796, 797, 98, 99.
That's it, 799. In and out. Just take deep breaths. In and out. It's okay. In and out. Remember, if you get both these prizes, you get a $1,000 bonus. I didn't want to tell you first because I didn't want you to fall over.
Okay.
You're
okay.
Ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go. Go to the bicycles and we'll show the audience the price. Don't tell her. Okay, and start bidding.
1,000.
Lower.
500.
Higher.
750.
Higher.
800.
Higher.
900.
Lower.
875.
Higher.
880.
Higher.
890.
Higher.
891, 892, 893, 894, 895, 896, 897, 898.
898! You won $1,000! Yeah! We'll be right back with more Prices Right right after this. Welcome back to The Price is Right. Rich, who's our next contestant?
Drew, it's going to be Nelson Rojas. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Nelson, how you doing? Welcome back. Welcome to the show. I just said welcome back like I know you before. Welcome to the show. Let's see the next item up for bid.
It's a lovely wall clock. This beautiful clock strikes every half hour with two brass bells and features beveled glass and a dark cherry finish.
That's right. Rachel and Brandy know what time it is, everybody. If anybody does. Nelson, what do you bid?
$750.
$750. Michael?
$400.
$400. Natalia?
I'll do $850.
What?
$850.
$850. Travis?
$899.
$899. And the actual retail price is... $1,500. Travis!
Oh my god, this is crazy.
It's crazy.
Yeah. I've been watching this since I was like three.
Have you always wanted to win a clock?
Yeah.
Well, you want a clock, and not only that, but get ready for this.
Okay. Travis, you're going to play Blink Deck for $250,000!
Travis, I have a Plinko chip for you right here. Here's a starter Plinko chip worth up to $10,000. Worth up to $10,000, and you can win four more Plinko chips to get, and they're all worth up to $10,000. She wants you to win $50,000. Rachel's over there, and she's going to show you prizes one by one, and you can win the prize or the Plinko chip. Let's see the first prize.
All right, Drew, first, making calls is fun with this telephone shaped like an old Shelby GT500.
Wow, yeah, always wanted one of those. It starts with a one or ends with a five?
One.
Starts with a one. The price starts with a one. No! Well, you didn't win one of those anyway. Let's see the next.
All right, second. The CD-DVD repair kit helps you keep your private information and favorite music in tip-top shape.
Private information. Now, the price starts with a nine or ends with a six?
Six.
Travis says six. Come on, Plinko chip. There you go. Travis gets a Plinko chip. Travis gets a Plinko chip. Let's see the third prize.
All right, third. This MP3 player features a cool, funky color with even cooler features.
A cool, funky color. Starts with a two. Eight?
Eight.
Eight. Travis says eight right away. Didn't even think about it. Eight. There it is. Plinko chip for Travis. Travis, you want a DVD thing and a cool colored pink thing? Yeah. Let's see the fourth one.
All right, finally, 12 bulbs illuminate this lantern to help keep you safe while camping.
Wow, you can listen to your cool MP3s while you're camping. Starts with a five, runs with a two.
Two.
Travis says two. Oh! You got two extra Plinko chips, though. That could be up to 30 grand. Here comes Gwen with the Plinko chips. Grab them, going up the stairs there. Travis, make your way on up. There goes Travis. Thank you, Gwen. A shot on the rowing machine, by the way. Now, here's how it works. You're going to put it up against the side, let it slide down. You want to land on the 10,000 one right in the middle here. That's the one you want, 10,000 one. Let it slide down there. There you go. It's going down the side. Travis, we want you to go in the middle. In the middle, in the middle. Oh, $100. Travis, that's not bad. $100 more than you came with, right? Plus you got the cool MP3 player and all that. Try it. Drop it one more time. You want the 10,000 one right here. That's what you want. There we go. Right down the middle, just where we want it. Here it comes. 10 grand, baby. There you go. Right down the side. No, back. $500. That's okay. $10,600 for Travis. I'm out of hand, everybody. Thank you. We'll be right back with more Price is Right right after this. Welcome back to the Price is Right television studio where I'm the mayor. Rich, who's our next contestant?
Drew, it's going to be Noreen Kesey.
Come on.
You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Yeah, Marie got a little cheering section over there. Wow, look at that. Hi, Noreen. How are you? Nice to see you. Two people with a Whose Price Is It Anyway shirt. I can't imagine the people. That's great. I appreciate you giving me, you know, I get money for the reruns, so thanks a lot. Rich, what's our next item up for bid?
Drew, it's a fun selection of games.
Yeah.
A family game collection featuring playing cards, chess, backgammon, domino, and mahjong sets, all in handcrafted wood.
A fun collection of games. We used to give away unfun games, but I'm changing all that. Noreen, what do you bid?
$750.
Nelson?
$850.
Michael?
$600.
$851. So Natalia, ready? The natural retail price is $805.
Noreen.
Noreen, who's this big group you're with the same shirt?
Brooklyn Escondido.
You're from what?
Escondido.
Yeah. What's the group?
Seventh-day Adventist Academy and Church.
Fantastic. Here, which, let me say, if you guys want to raise money for your church, here's what you can use for your next raffle. Let's hear it.
Noreen, it's a new sports car. A Pontiac Solstice comes with standard equipment plus 18-inch aluminum wheels, preferred package, and premium package, the Pontiac Solstice.
Yeah, you can touch it. Noreen, this is Brandy. Stand right over here, Noreen. Say hi to Brandy, driving the car. Nice driving, Brandy. Not all of her models can drive in a straight line. It's amazing. She made it all the way out here. Let's see the first price on the number of this car. Two. Now, you're from a Seventh-day Advent church, right? Now, we're playing a game called Lucky Sevens. Isn't that something? Here's seven $1 bills. This is all working out for you today, isn't it?
It really is.
Yeah. Now, here's what we're going to do. You're going to tell me the next numbers and the price of the car in order, and every time you're, whatever number you give me, however many numbers you're off, we're going to take that many dollars away from you. And you need $1 left when it's all over to buy this car. A dollar buys you this car. This is what kind of car is this?
It's a Pontiac Solstice.
Pontiac Solstice. I couldn't hear a thing either. Pontiac Solstice. So give me the next number and the price of this car.
Seven.
Seven. She says a seven. We're playing Lucky Seven. Let's see a seven. There it is. Marie, seven's the number today, I'm telling you. Let's have the next number and the price of this car.
Three.
What?
Three.
Three. Let's see a three. Four. That's not bad. Give me $1. You have $6 left and two numbers. You're doing pretty good, Noreen. Give me the next number.
Five.
Let's see a five for Noreen. Eight. Give me $3. You still have three. Yeah, it's going to be $3. You still have $3 left. And you need a dollar to buy the car. All you need is a dollar left to buy the car. Give me the next number. The car's yours.
483. Three.
Three?
Yeah.
Three. Let's see another three for Noreen. She says three again. Five. Give me $2. Give me $1 for the car. That's your car, Noreen. That's your finesse. That's your car. That's your car. Hop in. Hop in. There's your car. We'll be right back with more Price is Right, the Showcase Showdown right after this.
auctioning, paid for in part by the following.
Kill the cough. Naturally. New Halls Naturals with 100% natural menthol.
Welcome back to The Price is Right. Christina, 18 weeks pregnant. You're going to spin the first time on the wheel. Go ahead and spin the wheel. You want to get as close as you can to a dollar without going over. You get two spins if you need them. Go ahead and give it a big spin. 18 weeks pregnant. Take a deep breath. She's very nervous. Okay, that's okay. Go ahead and spin it. Don't do anything to hurt yourself. Okay, here we go. Big spin. And here it comes. It's official. Here it comes around, Christina. And it's going to 85, please. 50. 50, Christina, you want to spin again? Or?
Okay.
Okay, you're going to spin again. She's going to spin again. She has 50. Can't go over a dollar, remember? Go ahead. Rub your baby for luck. Rub my baby for luck. You rub your baby for luck. Yeah.
Hi to my family in Mission West Elementary. I love you guys.
Here we go. Coming around to 75 altogether. That's good. 75. Ready, Travis? There you go. You got to beat 75. You got two spins to do it. Got to beat 75. Want to say hi to anybody?
Hi, Mom and Grandma and everyone out in the crowd. Woo!
Thanks, Travis. This is going to take a while to go around. I can see, by the way, you spun it. And it goes a dollar. There goes 60. Here comes 75. Nope. It's going to stop at 40. Spin one more time because you need to get 75. And, wow, you got to put the spin on it. You better make up some more people to say hello to because we're going to be here forever.
Nobody.
Where are you from? What do you do? What's your hobby?
Willits, California.
Okay, we're done. Here we come to 65. Sorry, man. That's okay. That's okay. Noreen, you ready?
Oh, I'm ready.
Do you want me to help you spin it, or are you going to be okay? Okay, Noreen's going to spin it. There you go. Here you go, Noreen. You want to say hi to anybody while it's spinning?
Getting all the way around. Oh, I want to thank all the group that I'm here.
Oh, it didn't go all the way around. You got to spin it one more time. You get an extra spin to try. Ready? Nice and big. I'm going to help you out. Okay, there you go. There you go. That could be official. This is pretty good. You got the whole church group there to help you out. 15. One more spin because you have to beat 75. Ready? I'm going to help you. Here we go. And kaboom. Here we go. We got to be, what do we got? 15 now. We got to beat 75. So you need at least a 60. Oh, 75. That's it. That's it. We'll be right back for more Price Right. Hey, if you want to be a winner like Noreen, here's how you do it. Wow.
To order tickets online to The Price is Right, simply go to CBS.com and click on Shows. Under Daytime, select The Price is Right. Click on Ticket Information to find out how to get your tickets. It's that easy. Come on down. Okay, Drew.
We'll be right back with more Price is Right. Don't go away.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome back to Price is Right. We're giving away cars and everything here. It's great. Who's our next contestant?
Drew, it's going to be Kenna Petrie. Come on down. You're right, the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Aw, look, she's getting a hug. Making her way through. Aw, that's great. Come on down. Come on down, Kenna. High-fiving everybody. Here we go. Kenna, welcome to the show. Kenna, welcome to the show. Stiff competition up here. Oh, she's friends with everybody. What's the next item up for bid?
Okay, Drew. It's a durable luggage set. From Pathfinder Luggage, this four-piece set of luggage offers durability and function that will ensure your complete satisfaction. At Pathfinder, quality is everything.
Quality is everything. Nothing like durable luggage. I don't like the non-durable luggage. Kenna, what are you going to bid?
$350.
Nelson?
$900.
Michael?
$500.
Natalia?
If I don't get this, I'm going to feel stupid. $200?
$200. The actual retail price is $970. Nelson? What's your stuff? Nelson, how you doing, man?
Congratulations.
Thank you. I'm excited.
You should be excited. Let me show you why. Let's see the next game, or next prize.
It's a trip to beautiful Buenos Aires. Nelson, you and a guest will fly. Round trip coach from Los Angeles to Buenos Aires, Argentina for a six-night stay and fine accommodations. Enjoy the flavor of Buenos Aires with modern amenities.
Rachel, Nelson here says he's a Spanish teacher.
That's right. I'm a high school Spanish teacher.
Say something like, I'm excited about this in Spanish.
Bueno, estoy emocionado de ganar este viaje a Buenos Aires.
Okay. Whatever he said. The price of this, it's really easy to play. This trip either cost $11,251 or $9,415. You tell me which one it is, it's yours.
Oh, man.
You need a price, Nelson.
I'm going to go for the 11.
Says it's 11,251. Hold my hand. Say Shazam. Oh, your magic was not powerful enough. I'm sorry. We'll be brought back with more pricing games in the second half of Price is Right. You're okay, Nelson. Nice try, anyway. Thanks.
We'll make it to the final four. Survivor CBS Thursday.
Welcome back to Price is Right. Nothing wrong with the TV. I'm your new host. Let's see the next contestant.
Drew, it's going to be Haroon Rashid Cole. Come on down. You are the next contestant on the Price is Right.
Right in the front. Haroon Rashid, nice to see you, man.
Hey, Drew.
All right, let's see the next item up for bid.
It's a cool pair of surfboards. A surfer's most excellent prize, a pair of handcrafted surfboards and matching pair of wetsuits.
A most excellent prize. I thought you were supposed to get most excellent. I thought you were supposed to do that. Haroon Rashid, what do you want? What are you going to bid for this?
1450.
Michael?
$1,900.
Natalia.
$1,750.
Kenna.
$1.
Kenna says. The actual retail price, $1,330. Kenna. Thank you. You excited?
Yes, I'm so excited. I'm nervous.
Let's see what Kenna can win.
How about a lovely new dinette set? The strength of wrought iron combines with the beauty of a rich pine finish to create this country-style bittersweet dinette from Ashley Furniture. Subtle elegance from the Ashley Companies. Or, Kenna, maybe you'd like to win a new jean! The Jeep Wrangler X4x4 comes with standard equipment plus air conditioning, engine block heater, and locking fuel cap. The Jeep Wrangler!
Here, Kenna. Kenna, this is going to be so easy to do. Rachel's in that beautiful Jeep. That's what we want you to win. Let's see the first number and the price of that Jeep. A 1. Now, there's 10 digits available to you, 0 through 9, including another 1. You're going to give me digits, one after the other. We're going to fill in these numbers here. And the first one you fill in, that's the prize you win. Hopefully, it'll be the Jeep. So give me a number that's in the price of this Jeep.
9.
Let's see a 9 in the Jeep. There it is. Yeah, Lisa? Give me another number in the price of the Jeep.
5.
Show me a 5 in the price of the Jeep. Ooh, dinette. The dinette set's nice. We want the Jeep. I'll give you a Jeep.
7.
Let's see a 7 in the price of the Jeep. Yeah! Two more to go. You got a Jeep. Isn't that exciting? Give me another number.
4.
4. Let's see a 4 in the price of the Jeep. Oh. Kenna, you want that Jeep?
Three?
Let's see a 3 in the price of the Jeep for Kenna. Oh, that's okay. You still have a chance to get the Jeep.
And it has to be a different number than these, right?
It's all different numbers, yeah.
Okay.
I could, but you have another one to go to.
Six.
Let's see a six in the price of the Jeep. Oh, you got it done. That's it. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. We'll be right back with more prices, right? Oh, the Jeep is $19,710. We'll be right back with more prices right after this. Sorry, I'm new. I don't know all the rules yet.
Tech devices. Energize. Keep going.
Welcome back to The Price is Right in Hollywood. Rich, who's our next contestant?
Drew, it's going to be Denise Barker. Come on down. You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
Denise. All right. We're going to run. All right, Denise. Welcome to the show, Denise. What's the next item up for bid, please?
Drew, it's a fun trampoline. Think safety first with this new stage bounce trampoline and enclosure system from Jump Sport, a leader in backyard safety and innovation. Includes the popular ProFlex basketball goal. Stay fit, have fun, and play safely with Jump Sport.
Denise, what do you bid for that item?
828.
Rune Rashid.
650.
650. Michael.
900.
900. Natalia.
A dollar. A dollar.
A dollar. Somebody has the price right on the nose. Which means you get an extra $500 bonus if you are right on the nose. And the person with the price right on the nose is the one who put a bid up of $828. Denise!
Good.
You weren't up there. Look what I have for you in my pocket here. I have $500.
Oh, yeah.
There you go. Cash money.
It'll be so by the time
you don't even have to declare that type of IRS. I just gave it to you cash.
Thank you. Oh, I love you.
Rich, what else can she win?
Drew, how about a lovely bedroom groove? Presenting Casa Cristina from Pulaski, the elegance of Mediterranean style resonates with the warm essence of the islands in this collection by Cristina Sauri-Leggi from the Casa Cristina Furniture Collection by Pulaski. And a new mattress set. The Felicity Pillow Top from the Laura Ashley Home Mattress Collection features individually encased coils, memory foam, and a five-zone contour latex pillow top. Luxury through inspired design by Laura Ashley and Comfort Solutions. A terrific prize worth $10,058.
Worth $10,058. Denise, you're jumping around like you really need a bedroom set.
I love bedroom sets. I have a fetish.
Don't we all, huh, Rachel? Now, here's how you win that bedroom set. Me and Rachel, we're going to show you some items here, and then you are going to buy these items. Rachel's going to add them up on her little machine there, and then if you can buy $20 to $21 worth, you're going to win the bedroom fetish. You have a big fetish for bedroom sets. You're going to be so happy. Rich, what are the items?
All right, Drew, first, Kaboom, one powerful cleaner designed to tackle all of your bathroom's toughest stains. It's 100% tough on soap, scum, hard water, calcium, and lime stains. Enjoy tasty Italian dishes made with flavorful pasta sauce. Chocolate chip cookies can put a smile on your face, a perfect snack anytime. Enjoy pineapple slices, the fruit that makes every dish special. And use a little balm on your hands to relieve rough and dry skin. Drew?
Now, we're going to have you buy some items. We're going to have you buy some items. Whatever you want to buy first. Kaboom. What do you want to buy? You have to buy something.
I have to buy something.
Yes.
I want nine of these.
You want nine of these. Okay.
No?
Eight. She wants eight of these. These are $1.99 a piece. Eight times $1.99 is, that's not $15.92. Is that really right? Okay, good. Gotcha. I'm not good at math. That's why I'm a game show host. Let's see another one. What else do you want to buy? One Kaboom. $494.69 for the Kaboom. That's a grand total of $2,061. You're the bedroom set. Congratulations.
We'll be right back with the Showcase Showdown right after this. Don't go away.
The Kid Nation finale, Wednesday on CBS.
Closed captioning paid for in part by the following.
When you call 1-800-DENTIST, you get a real person who will listen to you and help you find the ideal dentist. 1-800-DENTIST. We take every smile personally.
Contestants not appearing on stage will receive from Arroyo combination exercise bikes, a recumbent and upright exercise bike in one unit. Remove the rear seat with just a click, the state-of-the-art method of getting fit from Arroyo CEB. And from Hummocka Hammocks, two tripod chair combos with footrest and pillow. These portable chairs are designed for comfort and ease and relaxation. From Hummocka, climb in and hang out. And now, here's Drew Carey with our Showcase Showdown.
Okay, oh, hey, welcome back to The Price is Right. Nelson, you're going to spin first because you didn't win. You won the least.
Yeah.
So go ahead. Give it a big spin.
Yeah, give it a big spin. Try to get as close as you can to a dollar without going over.
Come on.
Spin it around. Here we go. It's official in a second. It's going to stop at something high. I hope. Here comes the dollar. Here comes the dollar. It's a dollar on the nose. You win $1,000. Right there, baby. Dollar on the nose. An extra $1,000 for you to get to spin for a little bonus later.
You don't want to spin again, do you? No, you don't want to spin again. Okay, go ahead and spin. It's your turn. You got to get a dollar now. Got to get. Want to say hi to anybody? Okay, I'm sure they're so glad to hear from you. 80 cents. You got to spin again because you got to beat a dollar. Here we go. Spin one more time. Try to hit 20. Try to hit 20 cents right on the nose. Here it comes. No, you're not going to make it. Thanks very much. Didn't go all the way around. Oh, didn't go all the way around. You get one more spin. Let me give you a little break here on Price is Right. Then go all the way around. Okay, here we go. That was lucky. Because you need 20. You still need, there goes 20. All right, there you go. See ya. Sorry. Sorry, Kenna. Okay, ready? Give it a nice big spin. You got to get a dollar now to beat Nelson, who lucked out on that great spin.
Want to say hi to
Hi, Grandma Barker. I love you.
Grandma Barker. I love you too, Grandma Barker. 45 cents. Spin again. You need 55 on the button. Nice big spin. Where's Grandma Barker live?
Well, California.
All right.
Cool. Where, is that where you're from?
I'm from Reno, Nevada.
Reno, Nevada. Oh, so you gamble all the time. And okay, didn't make it. That's okay. Nelson, come here, buddy. Come here, man. Congratulations. Nelson got a dollar exactly, so I'm going to reset the wheel here. Here we go. Boom. We're going to reset the wheel of five right here. Now, you won $1,000 extra already. We're going to spin this one more time. It has to go all the way around. You don't get another spin. If you hit it on the dollar again, you win $10,000 extra. If you hit one of these green spots, you win an extra $5,000.
That's it.
I love you, Dana.
Dana, Nelson loves you, and here comes some money. Here it comes. Welcome back to The Price is Right. Let's see the first showcase, please.
This showcase contains prizes revealed as we let you know you might be living above your means. For instance, you might be living above your means if, after washing your hands, you refuse to use a towel and insist on drying your hands using this new pair of patio heaters. Enjoy the outdoors with this pair of stainless steel outdoor patio heaters. Each one creates a circle of warmth up to 20 feet. And you might be living above your means if listening to classical music from a CD isn't good enough for you, and you'll only listen to it performed live by a Philharmonic Orchestra in fabulous London. You and a guest will fly round-trip coach from Los Angeles to London for a six-night stay in elegant accommodations. Enjoy the historical sights and sounds of charming London. Finally, you're most likely living above your means if when you decide to order Chinese food for dinner, you only have it freshly delivered from the best restaurant in far-off China!
You and a guest will fly round trip coach from Los Angeles to Beijing, China for a six-night stay, including daily breakfast, courtesy of NWA World Vacations. Offering value-priced vacation packages exclusively from NWA World Vacations to destinations around the world. And this showcase, in which we can show you at least one way to determine if you're living above your means, can be yours if the price is right.
Far off China, as opposed to close by China. Noreen, you can bid on that prize or pass it on to Nelson. Can you bid on it or pass it on?
$21,700.
$21,700, says Noreen. Let's see the next showcase, please.
Nelson, your showcase contains prizes revealed as we visit the workshop of the Custom Candlestick Company. And our master craftsman made this first set of candlesticks for a huge baseball fan to celebrate the fact that he's headed off to Dodger Fantasy Baseball Camp. You and a guest will fly round trip coach from Los Angeles to Orlando and then travel to Dodger Town in Vero Beach, Florida for a six-night stay, including all instruction, uniforms, and meals at the Los Angeles Dodgers Adult Baseball Camp, a fantasy camp where you'll live, play, and train with baseball greats for an action-packed, fun-filled week from the Los Angeles Dodgers Adult Baseball Camp. And she's proud of these candlesticks because they're made for a huge TV fan who wanted something to go with her new big screen TV. This HDTV features a 1080p DLP light engine that displays clear, precise images on the huge 65-inch screen. Finally, she's crafted this set of candlesticks for a camper who wanted to have something that wouldn't clash with the scenery when sitting outside her brand new trailer. The Fleetwood Redline Hyperlite 230FS, this 27-foot travel trailer sleeps up to 8+ generator and interior value package, which includes queen-size bed with fold-away sleeper and an exterior value package, which includes heavy-duty walk-on roof. And your showcase, filled with candlesticks produced by the Custom Candlestick Company, can be yours if the price is right.
Nelson, what's your bid?
$28,500.
$28,500. We'll be right back to see who wins after this. Welcome back to The Price is Right. Nelson, you had the trailer, baseball fantasy camp, although Rachel is a bigger Indians fan than a Dodger fan, Dodger baseball fantasy camp. $28,500. Actual retail price, $47,447. For a difference of $18,947. Doreen, you want a car already? You want all kinds of nice prizes? Your
yes.
bid was $21,700 for all those nice trips to China and whatnot. And the actual retail price, $16,949. You went over. I'm sorry. Nelson, you win the showcase. Congratulations, Nelson. A total of $59,417 for the prizes for Nelson today. Please, don't forget to spay and neuter your pets. It's good for the animal population. We'll see you next time on Price is Right. Goodbye.
Good morning, I'm Andy Gannon. Coming your way in 1 hour on 23 News at noon. We'll keep you posted on the wintry weather working its way through the state line. How much more...
BS2 HD. Bob says goodbye. Join him in reminiscing on his amazing career. A salute to Bob tonight.
Here it comes! From the Bob Barker Studio at CBS in Hollywood. Television's most exciting hour of fantastic prizes. The fabulous 60-minute Price is Right! Melinda Storms Mosier, come on down! Robert Love, come on down. Leanne Aghetto, come on down. And Judith Buckingham, come on down. You are the first four contestants on The Price is Right. Here is the star, The Price is Right, Bob Barker!
after the Price is Right. I thank you, folks. Here's the first item up for bids today.
It's a new desktop computer. This powerful computer comes with a 460-gigabyte hard drive, color printer, and lots of gaming software.
And we will present that to the one of you four who bids nearest to the actual retail price without going over. Melinda, what do you bid?
$22.25.
Her bid is $22.25, and Judith says?
$18.99
to you, Robert.
$13.50, Bob.
$13.50, and now let's hear from Leanne.
$1, Bob.
$1 for Leanne. Actual retail price, $17.72. Robert, you are the winner. Robert, will you follow me, please? We're going right back here, Robert. This is where we are going to get it on. Now, Robert, right over here. This audience sounds to me as if it is rather enthusiastic anyway. But I think you would become even more enthusiastic if Robert wins this.
A new car! Robert, it's a Chevrolet Avail LP. Comes with standard equipment, plus four-speed automatic transmission, engine block heater, and anti-lock brakes. The Chevy Avail. It's a wonderful prize worth $15,315.
You have to spell car, C-A-R. Now, I am going to give you two cards, and I'm going to give you a chance to win three more cards. What is the number of one of the two cards I'm going to give you that you would like to have? He wants 16. We'll give him 16. Now, I said I'd give you two cards. What number do you want for your second card?
Four, Bob.
He wants four. Here's four. Now, I told you that you could win three more cards, and with those three cards, there are prizes, are there not, Rich?
Sure are, Bob. First, enjoy movie night at home using this stainless steel popcorn maker. Want clean floors? Get a cleaner mop. The redesigned Living Wonder Mop has a machine washable mop head, so you always start with a fresh mop. And feed the whole team their favorite food using this football field inspired slow cooker.
You take a look at that corn popper, and you tell me what you believe the price is. If you get it right, within $10 above or $10 below, we'll give you the corn popper and give you another car. What do you say?
24.
He says $24. What is the right price? $24. Can you believe it? Now, who told you $24? Have him stand. This lady? The lady?
Nope.
No, where? Which one? The fella in front row? Did you tell him $24? You watch the show every day, and you have seen that corn popper before, haven't you? No? All right. I was going to compliment him for being a loyal friend and true, but he denies that he's learned it. Now, the important thing about the $24 is that when you get one of those exactly right, we automatically give you all of them. So you have the corn popper, you have the mop, and you have the slow cooker, and you have three more cards. Now, what number do you want? Wants number 12, so let's give him number 12. There you are. Another number.
21, Bob.
21 coming up. And one more. What number do you want?
17.
17 it is. Now you have five cards here, and on each of them, as you can plainly see, we have $500. Five times $500 is $2,500, and that's exactly what we would be happy to give you right now. $2,500 cash, and forget the car.
I'll go for the car.
He wants to go on. What do we have here? We have C. You want to take $2,000 and quit, or do you want to move ahead?
Keep going.
He wants to go on, and here we have C. Now, that's not good. Now, you tell from the audience reaction, that's not good. You want to quit now and take $1,500?
I'll keep going.
He wants to go on, and here we have a C. Now, this situation is genuinely serious. You would have to have an A and an R, or one of the cards, two on the board, on which it says car, in order to win that car. You can still take $1,000 and quit. Do you want to quit?
I want to take the money.
He's going to take the money and quit. He is going to take the money and quit. Now, would it be a traumatic experience for you if we should discover that you could have won the car? Because I won't look. But if you can take it, if it's possible. I know he's going to take the money. You're going to take. I'm not arguing with that. I just want to know, could you have won the car? There's the R. Now, this is the all-important car. And guess what? It's another C. So you did exactly the right thing. Congratulations. More, I say, after these words. Who was our next contestant, Rich?
Bob, it's Nell Hegwald. Come on now! You're the next contestant on The Price is Right!
It sure is! We'd all know her anywhere. She looks as if she might be slightly stunned. But now she's ready. Right down here. Here you are. There you are, Nellie. And look at the next item up for bid.
Here it comes now, right on the turntable. It's new dumbbells. For my Vanco, colored dumbbells with heavy-duty rack. Dumbbells are in hot colors with neoprene and vinyl coverings. They're comfortable to use and won't rust from my Vanco Barbell Company. And to the winner of these dumbbells goes a supply of skincare. Derma is the number one doctor and pharmacist recommended product for scars. Helps soften, smooth, and reduce the appearance of the old and new scars. With Mederma, use as directed.
Nellie, what do you bid on that prize? Her bid is $7.99, and Leanne, what do you say?
$5.50, Bob.
$5.50, back to Melinda.
$7.12.
Her bid is how much?
$7.12.
$7.12. Now, Judith.
$6.50.
The actual retail price is $6.99, and the winner is Judith. Judith, will you join me, please? I'm going to leave Judith right back here. We have a game all ready to go here, Judith. Right back here, you are going to play Safe Cracker. There are two prizes in that safe, and the lovely Rachel will swing that door open so that you can see the two prizes that you can win.
First, a big screen TV. 1080p technology delivers digital cinema quality on this 52-inch DLP HD TV. See exceptional images every time. And how about a new karaoke machine? From Party Time Karaoke, a fun karaoke machine and music package featuring some of the best-sounding karaoke music on the market. Have fun singing karaoke with your friends and family from Party Time Karaoke. It's a Safe Crackers prize package worth $3,759.
Lock that safe. And Judith has told me that she knows all our games. This one. So step right over here and let me show you the numbers in the price. 0, 5, or 6. And a 9, the numbers and the price of the karaoke machine. Go ahead, you know what to do. Set the first dial on the first number and the price, the second on the second, the third on the third, and you're a winner. She has it at $6.90. Turn that wheel. Pull on that handle. Oh! Yes, of course, you're right. $9.60 instead of $6.90. Thank you very much, Judith. We'll play another pricing game after these words.
Sunday.
We are about to meet
Daryl Simonson. Come on down.
He is out of there in a first, and he's in contestant show. And now, my beauties are bringing out something for y'all to bid on. Have a look.
It's lovely dinnerware. Radiant contemporary China dinnerware from Royal Dalton is pristine white, set off by an ornate dark red design and completed with a platinum trim. Truly elegant dining from Royal Dalton. And to the winner of this dinnerware goes a supply of candy. Russell Stover, sugar-free candies taste so good, you won't believe they're sugar-free.
Daryl, start the bidding on that prize.
$800.
$800. Nellie is next.
$850.
Leanne.
$1,250, Bob.
$1,250. $1 for Melinda. The actual retail price is $1,801. You're the winner, Leanne. Let's go play a pricing game. We're going to have a long walk, but we hope it will be worth it for her. Right back here we are, right over here, right beside me, so that you can see all these prizes.
A charming day bed, an electric guitar, and a riding lawnmower. First, from Wesley Allen, this aged iron Montana daybed adds a touch of elegance and style to your home. And discover America's premium mattress from Loving Care, because so much depends on how you sleep. This four-foot mattress is only one way to treat yourself with Loving Care, America's premium mattress. Second, this HP Signature electric guitar and Valve King tube amplifiers are the ultimate in tone, style, and technology that PV has perfected during its 40-year history, only from PV. And finally, this riding lawnmower by Husqvarna bridges the gap between a yard tractor and a garden tractor, featuring a 26-horsepower Briggs & Stratton engine. Extraordinary power at an extraordinary value. Husqvarna!
Leanne has come all the way across the country from Florida to win these three prizes, playing most expensive. Okay. Which prize is the most expensive? Number one, number two, or number three? Which one is it?
Three, Bob.
Number three is the most expensive. What is the price of number one? $1,243. What is the price of number two? $1,550. If number three is more than $1,550, you are a winner. Show us that prize. You are a winner. Congratulations. Yes. Thank you. Showcase Showdown coming up.
Changes everything.
Closed captioning paid for in part by the following.
Buddy.
It's the extra creamy ice cream you don't have to feel guilty about. Double churn from Breyers.
It is wheel spinning time on The Price is Right, and here's our first wheel spinner. And here's our first spin. Get a dollar, we'll give
you
a dollar.
Can I say hi to MJ at home? Wish you were here and all my friends and family in Little Falls, Minnesota.
And you got that all done and ended up with a nickel. I bet you're going to spin again. Here goes spin number two. 95 cents. No, I don't think that'll get her off. How about eight? No. 35. 35 and five, 40 cents. And here comes Robert. You have to beat 40 cents to take over the lead. Are you going to be able to do it with one spin? Yes, you are. You have 85 cents. You are the leader. And you have to beat 85 cents to get into the showcase, Leanne. Spin that wheel. And she did. And what do we have for Leanne?
Could I say hi to Julie, Jason, Dorma, and Kevin?
We have another spin is what we have. You have 35 cents. Spin it again. 35 cents. And what will we add to it? No, you have gone over. Thank you, Leanne. Robert, you will be in the showcase at the end of the show. And folks, we have lots more fun coming up after this announcement.
Sea Change, CBS Tuesday.
Rich.
Yes, sir.
Who will it be?
It's going to be Delaina Young. Come on down. You are the next contestant on The Price is Right.
On her feet bounding, but she's not getting any play. Here she comes now, hopping into contestant's row. What will you bid on, please?
It's a handy luggage stand. Travel in style with these three-piece celebrity travel sets in King of Rock and Roll Elvis Presley, Forever Beautiful Marilyn Monroe, and Legend of Hollywood James Dean, making your next trip much more enjoyable from EliseHandbags.com. And the winner of this luggage set goes to Supply Battery Dispensers. With the Energizer Easy Change, any place is a good place to change your hearing aid batteries. Energizer, keep going.
Bidder number one is Delaina.
$600, Bob.
Delaina has bid $600. How about you, Melinda?
What did you bid? I'm sorry.
$600.
$675.
Her bid is $675, and here's Daryl.
$700.
$700, and Nelly. Nelly bid $701. One of you four is exactly right, and the one of you who has bid exactly right will receive a bonus of $500. The bonus will go to the contestant who bid $600. Delaina, come up here. $100 bill. Now, ladies and gentlemen, Delaina is excited about her $500, and we're excited for her. But wouldn't it be much, much more exciting if Delaina should win that?
A new car! The Dodge Caliber SE comes with standard equipment, plus front and rear floor mats, air conditioning, and satellite digital radio. The Dodge Caliber!
Now, Delaina, I am going to show you a price for that car, then a higher price, a higher price, a higher price. I'll go on as long as you want me to. But the moment that you see a price that is higher than the actual price of that automobile, I want you to say that's too much. Now, have you seen this game on our show?
No, I haven't.
You have not. Well, I don't want you to just say that's too much.
Okay.
I want you to sound like a Marine drill sergeant. Let me hear you.
That's too much.
That's perfect. Here's the first prize right here. 14, 6 points.
Higher.
15,206.
Higher.
And on we go to 16,120.
Higher!
Have a look at 17,140.
Higher!
Here's the next price, 18,331.
Higher.
Higher, but not so forcefully. 20,440.
That's too much!
That's too much at 20,442. Is she a winner? No. What's the price, Gwendolyn? 15,510. You should have stopped clear back here. Delaina, thank you. Folks, more pricing games coming up on the second half of The Price is Right.
Yes, tomorrow.
Now, folks, I want to remind you all that tonight at 8, 7 Central, CBS is celebrating my 50 years on television with a very special Price is Right. Not only will there be prizes, games, and lots of fun, you'll see many of the highlights of my 50 years on television. Remember, that's tonight at 8, 7 Central. Don't you miss it. All right, Rich, let's have a name, if you please.
All right, Bob, it's Manuel Rivero. Come on down.
You're the next contestant on The Price is Right.
They threw him out of there, and here he is in contestant throw, and here is the next item up for bid.
It's a handy wine cooler. You'll never be without your favorite Chardonnay with a 75-bottle capacity wine cooler from Danby with interior light, tempered glass door, 8 beechwood shelves, and precision LED controls from Danby.
And look who's here. Take a look at this little puppy. That little guy, that guy is here from the Department of Animal Services, City of Los Angeles, and he's up for adoption. He's only 2.5 months old, and when he was brought over, he didn't have a name, but we've named him Plinko. That's his name, Plinko. So if you'd like to have Plinko in your home, you get over to the Department of Animal Services, City of Los Angeles, and he will be a part of your family for years to come. Plinko needs a home. If you don't live out here, you can find a friend like that at a shelter near your home. Now, Manuel, what do you bid on that prize?
$1,500.
His bid is $1,500, and I turn to Melinda.
$1,201.
Her bid is $1,201. What is yours, Darren?
$900.
$900, and now Nellie.
$1,199.
And you have all overbid. The lowest bid is $900. Erase the bids, please. Go lower than $900, Manuel.
$750.
His bid this time is $750. What is yours, Melinda?
$799.
$799. Now, Daryl.
$700.
$700. Nellie. $1. The actual retail price, $699. And Nellie, you win. Come up here. Nellie, you win. He went over. Nellie's up here with me. Nellie, come right back to sight. Now, Nellie, you are the grandmother of some of the folks in our audience.
Yes, right? I am.
And I think that a grandmother could, you have to buy Christmas gifts and things for all these kids, don't you?
Yes.
I have just the thing for you, don't I, Rich?
Sure do, Bob. It's a chance to win up to $10,000 in cash.
There you are. You can win $10,000, but you have to start with just $1. Now, what is the target price today, please? It's $6. Now, you've seen this game, haven't you?
Yes, I have.
You know that you have to pick out products that are less than $6. So listen as Rich tells you all about the products.
All right, Bob, will do. First, Tom Smoothies Berry Fusion. They dissolve fast, they work fast. Fast relief never tasted so good. Use as directed. Purina Cat Chow Indoor Formula contains the wholesome grains and garden greens your indoor cat craves. Physical, emotional, complete. That's a Purina Cat Chow way of life. Refresh Tears is the easy answer for dry eye relief. Refresh Tears is fast-acting and long-lasting, so eyes feel good wherever you are. Use as directed. Add a touch of fragrance to your home with Glade Plug-ins Gel Extra Outlet Nightlight. Each holder gently warms the fragrance-infused gel cartridges to gradually release your favorite Glade fragrance for 30 days. Campbell's Cream of Mushroom, good casserole possibilities. And cook and bake with light olive oil specially created for the different foods you cook today.
Now, what have you picked out that you believe is less than $6?
The soup.
The soup? Clear down here. The soup. It is $1.07. So you're up to $10. Now what? Cat food, she believes, is less than $6. Oh! It's $6.99. Antacid, $4.21. Eye drops. There's the other one that's more than $6. Air freshener, less. And olive oil, less. Nellie, you came to The Price is Right and won $10.
Yay!
I'll see you later at the big wheel. We will be back with more fun prizes, who knows what, after this.
8709.
And we await the name of our next participant, if you please, Rich.
Sure, Bob, it's going to be Margaret Scalia. Come on down. You're the ex contestant on The Price is
Wherefore
Right.
Wherefore art thou? Oh, here she comes. And she's moving fast. Yes, and squealing all the way. Margaret, I welcome you to Contestants Row. Now, I do believe Gwendolyn has something for them to bid on, don't you, Gwendolyn? She does.
It's a gorgeous ladies' diamond watch. Eleni's Dolce is simply sweet, the perfect combination of beauty and elegance, featuring 0.30 carats of diamonds and a spectacular stainless steel strap to give it a chic look from Eleni.
And for the first bid on that watch, I shall call upon you, Margaret.
$14.99.
What do you think, Manuel?
$1,200.
$1,200. Melinda? It's been a long day. You've been down there ever since I came through the big door.
I know.
Let's see if you can pull it out at the last moment.
$822.
Daryl, you get the last bid.
$1.
$1 for him. The actual retail price is $10.99. Melinda did pull it out at the last moment. She was one of our first four contestants, and here she is up on the stage. Here we are, Melinda. Congratulations. Yes, I'm proud of you. Now, what can she win next?
Bob, how about a new trailer? It's a little guy, 5-wide platform trailer with NASCAR graphic, lightweight to tow easily, yet big enough for a queen-size mattress. www.golittleguy.com.
Now, you can win that by simply straightening this mess out. You see, these numbers belong side by side. They belong this way if you believe the price of that prize is $6,670. But they belong this way, side by side, if you believe the price is $7,066. Now you step over here and put them side by side correctly, and that prize is yours. You believe the prize is $6,670. Is she a winner? Yes! Yes! She's a winner! Congratulations! And we are ready for the second showcase showdown. We'll do a little business with you.
Closed captioning paid for in part by the following.
Weight Watchers chocolates by Whitman's. Eight delicious and sensible ways to satisfy your sweet tooth with a points value of just one per piece. Make a great choice with Weight Watchers chocolates by Whitman's.
Contestants not appearing on stage will receive the Morgan Mint Quality Collectibles featuring classic American coins and official Elvis Presley memorabilia honoring the King of Rock and Roll. You need gifts from the Morgan Mint and a security mailbox. You'll get identity theft protection with this baseball bat-proof steel mail locker. Finally, the world has a better mailbox, the self-locking mail locker from Janmark.com. And now, here's Bob Barker with our showcase showdown.
I thank you, Rich. Now, Nellie
yes?
has asked me to help her spin the wheel. Now, you grab the... Are you ready? Let's do it! You weren't much help. I had to do that all by myself, Nellie. And I'll bet you want to spin again.
Yeah.
Don't you, or do you? I don't know. That's 50... All right. Now, you help me. I'm not going to just help you. I'm not going to do it by myself. There, now, you did a little better that time. You got 55 cents the first time. And look at this, Nellie. No, it's not going to stop. But, stop. That's a pretty good score. You have 80 cents. Come on, Delina, and spin that wheel. Delina has to beat 80 cents. And Delina has that thing flashing before our eyes and about to come to a stop on 65. Do it again. One more time, Delina. 65 cents. And where There's 35. There's 35. That won't get around again. 65, this is not good. This is expensive. Thank you very much, Delina. It is your spin, Melinda. Step right over there and do it to it. Here she goes with spin number one. She has to be 80 cents to get into the showcase, and she is not going to do it with one spin. 75. One more time. There goes spin number two. 75 cents. And too much money. Thank you, Melinda. Nellie, you're the winner. Congratulations. You are going to be in the showcase and have a chance to do more winning following this announcement. Robert, you are the top winner in our showcase today. And Grandma Nellie is the runner-up. Each of you will have a showcase of beautiful prizes to bid on. The one of you who bids closer to the actual retail price of your own showcase without going over will win it. But if you are the winner and you're $250 or less away from the retail price of your own showcase, we will give you both showcases. Now, feast your eyes on showcase number one.
This showcase lets you visit some exciting islands, such as historic Alcatraz Island and fascinating San Francisco. You and a guest will fly a round trip from Los Angeles to San Francisco, California for a five-night luxury stay courtesy of Southwest Airlines Vacations. Complete packages of fun, including airfare, hotel, and more. Save time and money on your next getaway with a vacation package from southwestvacations.com. Next, you're headed for the exotic type of islands found in beautiful Fiji. You and a guest will fly a round trip coach from Los Angeles to Maui, Fiji for a six-night cruise, including meals and non-motorized water sports aboard Blue Lagoon Cruises. Imagine waking every morning to a new paradise. Visit remote Fijian islands while swimming in some of the most beautiful waters in the world. You can call us your floating resort from Blue Lagoon Cruises. Finally, you'll be able to find any type of island you want with your very own sailboat. The West White Potter 19-foot sailboat, designed for greater stability and smooth sailing with its hard-sheen hull design. It sleeps four plus select package, colored hull, opening ports, and trailer. And this showcase filled with islands can be yours if the price is right.
Now, do you want to bid on this showcase or pass it over to Nellie?
I'm going to pass.
You are going to pass to Nellie. Nellie, what do you bid on this showcase?
$21,500.
$21,500 for Nellie. Now, Robert, this is your showcase.
Robert, your showcase tells you about some little-known rockers of the past. For instance, there was Jim Scorison, who was known to write music while he scored on his new video arcade game. Rediscover the classic excitement of Ms. Pac-Man with his video arcade game. Evade pesky ghosts and gobble fruit for bonus points for hours of fun. Next, there was Mick Jagger, a guy who mixed beautiful melodies while mixing beautiful drinks at his new bar set. Johnson Casual's four-score contemporary bar set features a glass-top table and four bar stools with colorful fabric seats. A great addition to your home from Johnson Casuals. And then there was an amazing little guy named Minnie Van Halen, who, of course, did all his composing inside a brand new minivan. It's the Dodge Caravan SE. Comes with standard equipment plus metallic paint, rear window defroster, and radio with cassette and CD player, and engine block heater. And Robert, your showcase filled with some little-known rockers can be yours if the price is right.
Having had a long look at that, Robert, what are you going to bid on that showcase?
$22,300.
He has bid $22,300 on his showcase, and Nellie has bid $21,500 on her showcase, and we will find out which one of them has bid better after we see it.
What?
Are you ready for some prices? Robert, you bid $22,300. Robert, the actual retail price of your showcase is $26,109, a difference of $3,809. Over to Grandma Nellie. She bid $21,500. Nellie, the actual retail price of your showcase is $27,342, a difference of $5,842, and the winner is Robert. And here is a whole crowd of folks who love that idea. Bob Barker reminding you, help control the pet population. Have your pet spayed or neutered. Goodbye, everybody.
This is Rich Field speaking for The Price is Right. I'm Mark Goodson, Television Productions.